Alright, this is a tutorial for Halo Combat Evolved speedrunning on easy difficulty. The first thing we want to do when you get into this cryotube is change your look sensitivity to inverted. And you can do this, we're going to change this back again, but it will save time. You can also do this a little bit faster by escape, up, up, enter, down, down, right, enter, up, up, enter. And if you do it fast, it looks like this. Oh, crap. Sort of fast. And let's see, yeah, we're inverted now. So we're good to go. Once you get out of this cryotube, you want to not move and not look anywhere at all. So you'll be looking at this guy and he will start talking. And then just wait for him in this red like thingy. Just hit the lights. There's not really a way to speed this up. Right here, you want to look down all the way, and you can change your inversion, look inversion back to a normal, and unless you like playing on inverted. And you just go escape, up, up, enter, down, right, enter, up, up, enter. And there's a small change if you play on sensitivity free, because sensitivity free is the default. So if you're on inverted and you have three sensitivity, you can do it like this: escape, up, up, enter, down. Oh wait, I'm not. Escape, up, up, enter, down, enter, and then you go up to go to default, and then enter. And then it switches immediately to non-inverted, and you will still keep your sensitivity at the right, at free. And then you just go right, enter, and then up, up, enter. It's a little bit faster, but you don't want to change your sensitivity to save those 0.3 seconds or something. Now I'm gonna change it back to 1 because that's what I like to play. Alright, once you're all set, then you can stand like right here, and look right here. This is a specific spot and a specific place to look, but it doesn't. The point is that he stops where you're looking. So he turns around immediately and then he will start talking immediately. And then hold E to activate this thing. And then we have to wait for this door, but we can speed it up slightly by standing in a specific position in front of the door. You want to be standing in front of this part of the door. So like this. It's not very precise. Then you need to look up here. And after the door explodes, you can look back. And hopefully Sam will not scream a lot. After that, you can hit your head off this thing, like this, to jump over these pipes. You can do it the way I just did by pressing A, or you can just look left and jump. Here you can hit your head off this thing to go over those marines. And here you can either jump from right here and crouch at the end, and crouch like here. Or you can look over here and bounce your head off this if you stand still. Basically you want to change your method on the marines, like if they're marines, like these marines, if they're frantic, then you want to jump over them. Here you can cross an invisible line here and then go back to skip having to walk all the way to keys.
I don't keep it loaded, so
and now we want to be as fast as possible. We want to get out of here. Because if you do this fast, then this will skip the grunts here and open this door immediately.
Those Marines could use some help, Chief. Do what you do best.
Here you want to shoot the grunts and walk around the elites. Sometimes the elites can block you really bad, but it's easy, so the elites are pretty easy to kill.
What the hell?
And here you just want to cut corners. And looking down is a little bit easier, makes it a little bit easier to cut corners. Because you can see where you're going, because the FOV in this game is pretty shitty. Right, there's a grunt, usually that comes around this corner. You can shoot him, and usually there's one right here. You can shoot him. I try this elite that was just here. I try not to shoot him, because if he's right here and you shoot him, then he will try to melee you and probably block you, so try to shoot the grunts and move around the elite. Here I shoot this marine to prevent him from doing a barrel roll and block me. I can melee this elite, and usually there's a grunt here, you can shoot him pretty easily. And there will be an elite coming out of this door, and if you're lucky he doesn't block you, if you're unlucky he does. And you can kind of play around with it, because if you shoot like right here and he's right there, then he will usually walk out. But it's kind of tough to predict, because sometimes he will be right there and sometimes he will be already walking out. So right now I see that he's already walking out, and then there's no use shooting, so you just walk around him. Alright, for this part you will want to get up there. There's like three different ways. One is the very basic way. So just walk up the stairs and jump right here. The second one is the one I usually do. It's pretty fast and very consistent. You walk right to this step, these two steps, these two darker steps. Jump left, crouch jump. And then jump from this stair to up there. If you jump from right here, you're not gonna make that jump. Then the last one is, you want to walk up this line and walk up until this stair. And then we want to jump on this thing. And you can use your, you can use D to get up there. Because this thing is kind of slippery, so you can easily fall off. Then you want to crouch jump up this thing. And you're just a bit faster than going around there. So fast it would look like this if I can do it. This guy is in the way. Get up here, jump up here. Then kill these guys to make sure they don't block you. As well as these guys and these grunts. And here I will make a save. And I will save this checkpoint. Alright. Want to go look left here and then shoot the grunts. And you can look up. And if you get this checkpoint, after she says we have to use the maintenance access ways, then you can load the last checkpoint and it will save some time, because it will skip that dialogue and then you get the tutorial immediately and then you can mash enter. So go back here. Look left and then shoot the grunts.
We should hurry.
And then look up.
Blast door is closing. We have to
And now I got the checkpoint very early, so I can't do the trick. And now you just wait for this tutorial. You mash enter to skip it. And wait for this door. Go left here.
I'm detecting Covenant movement outside the access ways. Activating motion tracker. Let's find a safe exit.
Alright, for this part, there can be an elite right here. Right now he is. So you want to melee him, then go right, jump, and mash enter. So melee him, go right, jump, mash enter. And if there's a ground light there, melee him.
It looks like the Covenant wanted to catch you napping.
And then shoot these grunts and bounce your head off this to get here faster. Shoot this grunt. Make sure you don't get blocked here. Shoot some enemies if you need to. Here as well, you can like make a jump here. That's really nice. And for this last part, we want to kill all of these enemies, and then we want to go like right over there and then mash enter to complete the level. So what we do is you throw a grenade here, and hopefully a grunt doesn't block you and doesn't block the grenade like this. All right, he's being mean. Yeah, he's gonna do it every time. Right, for one there, for one in the back. I'm getting really unlucky here. Come on, for one here, for one in the back. Shoot the elite, and then get mesh enter here. All right, this is Halo. First off, you can skip this cutscene by pressing enter.
Chief, can
and
you hear
then,
me?
Once coming out of the pod,
are you all right?
You can grab some frags, and we're going to do the first grenade jump of the game. At this rock, or more like this ledge, to get up there.
I've detected multiple Covenant dropships on approach.
Let's save first.
I recommend moving into
those. And we're going to jump from about here to here, and then up there. Jump and hold jump the entire time. And then when you're over here, go look to the right of this black spot for a frag, then walk a bit back and jump forwards. And there you go. So do it one more time. Put down a little bit faster.
Recommend moving into those hills. If we're lucky, the Covenant will believe that everyone aboard this lifeboat died in a crash.
And then you're up here. Now right now I can explain backpack reloading, which is just when you need to reload. You can double tap R and then switch to your other weapon. And if you come back then to your other weapon, it will be reloaded. So basically it reloads in your backpack, and that's why it's called that way. And it's very useful for combat. And I try to, when I reload, I will always do a backpack reload because it's useful. For example, in the upcoming area.
I'm reading a lifeboat beacon over the next hill. We should check to see if there are any survivors.
Alright. For this area, eventually we want to get a warthog, and for the warthog we need to clear six of these ships, and actually one of these ships is skippable, and for that we need to kill five of our marines so that the marines don't give us dialogue which slow down these ships. Also what you need to do is grab two plasmas during the first two ships to skip one of the ships, and it's useful as well to grab some frags along the way if those marines drop any. So first we're going to do the first ship, which is just shooting the grunts with the pistol. And then using the AR to kill the elite. Alright. After that, we're going to kill these marines. You start with these two, and then you walk up this ramp and kill those, one of those, and then get up there and kill two of those. And so it looks like this. Kill these two. If they drop any frags, grab them. And kill one of them. And then kill these two. And if you do that fast enough, you should be able to skip the dialogue, which will be done if the ship that is now coming down, it will halt in the air for a moment and it will do that dialogue. But if you are fast enough at killing those five, then it won't do it. Alright, now we're going to grab some frags and ammo. And you can crouch here to negate your fall damage. Shoot him five times. And then throw the frag and then kill him. Alright. And kill anything that's remaining. Right now there is a rule. If you kill so much there are two or less enemies remaining in the area, then the next ship will spawn. So that's our goal with clearing these ships as fast as possible. So you don't have to clear everything immediately, but kill as many enemies so fast that there are two or less enemies remaining after you throw grenades or something. And right now I picked up some plasmas from this elite, which I will need here. You can try and shoot this grunt out of the ship. And you don't want to come too close to these ships, or else they won't come down if you're right under them. Alright, so let's do that one more time to explain what I actually did. I have plasmas, yes. So there's like an invisible line, like in the shadow. If you go past the shadow, it won't come down if you wait there. So I wait a little bit here and then it comes down. The timing of this plasma needs to be that the timing hits the ground, that the plasma hits the ground as soon as this dropship comes to a stop. And I actually got only one remaining after the frag and the plasma, and that means I got the... It was fast enough. You can shoot, try to shoot some grunts out of the ship. And again, we're going to throw a plasma and a frag. And the timing is about the same as the second ship. We want to throw this plasma at the right moment, so that it like lands on the ground as the ship comes to a stop. And if you don't get it, then wrong, there will be a ship here. Let me explain that for a bit. There will be a ship where I just looked, and you go to that one first and clear that. But it's not really that important, because the ship what I'm looking at right now is on a timer from when you clear that, it's on a timer after the fourth ship, or the ship I just want that now isn't there. That ship, if that ship spawns, then this ship, which we're looking at right now, is on a timer. So it doesn't matter how fast you clear the one that now isn't here. This fifth ship will come in anyway. So let's see. Yeah, you can just go over there and then kill those, and then you go to this one. And this one, clearing this one goes as follows. You shoot the four guns on the left, and throw a frag under this hatch. Things you need to think about for this ship is that you don't want to throw the frag too fast. If you throw it too fast, then the hitchhikers won't have come out of the ship yet. And don't throw the frag like this. Because the hitbox is kind of large, so I've made the mistake a couple of times. So make sure you're like standing away from the ship. But usually you won't kill the grunts fast enough so that your grenade is already delayed. Get back up here and get some ammunition and frags, which is most important. Sometimes this guy may drop some frags, that's why I keep him alive in the first area, in like before the ships come down. And then just grab some plasmas and a plasma pistol and kill this guy. Mash onto here to skip the tutorial. And if you don't kill this guy in the turrets right there, it doesn't really matter. You get another chance here in the tunnels to kill him.
This cave is not a natural formation.
But you need to kill him in the tunnels. But if you kill him, if you don't kill him after you get out of the tunnels, then it's you're gonna have a problem because you might anger some marines and he might not allow you to get back into the warthog.
I'm going to use your suit's transcom system to monitor their chatter.
I should explain this jump. I try to level my warthog out to get off the ledge at like a right angle. And it's a bit kind of RNG whether you do a nosedive or not. Sometimes it can go really low and you might slow down a little bit and not have the enough speed to make it across this gap. But you can also do a somewhat safer strat, but a little bit slower. You can bounce your warthog off there and just turn around, and then you will have enough speed. Right here we're going to do the first warthog fling. I'm going to make a save here because I want to introduce you to the fling first. Warthog fling is basically launching yourself with the warthog. Like that. And it, you do it like... You do it by pressing E, then turning, and then pressing space. E, turn, space. Or like it depends, you can turn earlier, but make sure you press space at like the last second, because space also slows your warthog down. And the fling here is like this. You fling against the wall and you get up here. And the line for where you need, when you need to press E, is, I use this one, when the front of my warthog is on this line, I press E and start turning. And I make sure that I turn quite a bit, because I think it's that your player model gets squished between the wall and the back of the warthog, and that pushes you upwards. So one more time. E, turn, and then space at the last second. And jump over here. Activate this. And here you could have killed if the marine was there, you couldn't kill him. Either with the plasma pistol or the magnum. When you leave here, you want to get on like this thing. And it's important that you don't do too high or too low. And it's like right here, your front wheel needs to hit this spot of the ramp. And make sure you turn a lot. So like this. Basically, it feels like you're going sideways over on, up to that ramp.
There's new traffic on the Covenant battle network. A lot more
right for the upcoming areas. We're going to
really gave them hell.
Kill some Marines. We're actually supposed to save them, but it's a lot faster to just kill them and leave the area instead of fighting all the Covenant. So we just do that. And that's why the frags are important, because frags are really useful in killing Marines. Before we kill any Marines, we're going to grab a sniper. And what's important for grabbing the sniper is when you get out of the Warthog. So you see like this line before the before you get like for the ramp or the little hill thing. When the front of your Warthog is on this line, then you want to get out. So now. And then hold E to go over the sniper. If you slow down a little bit, just a tiny bit, on this hill you might actually go low enough to grab a frag as well that's around here. So if you're low on frag, you can frags, you can do that as well. And I was actually low on frag, so I'm glad I grabbed it. Here, just go slightly to the left over this and slow a bit down, and then do the fling on this shadow. It's a bit bad. Let's do that again. Slow down a little bit, and then E turn space, and you just get over. Just these grunts if they get in your way, and then throw a frag like around here. It doesn't. You should throw it where the most Marines are, but usually the most Marines are over here, and then you kill the rest of them by just shooting them. Either the pistol of the or the sniper. For this trick, you kind of want to know when to press shift, because if you press it too soon or too late, it might be hard to get up there. But you can see on my noteboard like when to press it. And you notice that you bounce a little bit if you get up here, so wait till you're stationary and then press D in space and hold D in space. And then you get over here and get into the Warthog.
We didn't rescue any of the Marines. 100% casualties.
Cortana to Echo 419. Go Hammer, relay the evac order.
Alright, we're on to the next area. To kill some Marines. And this next area is really random in where the Marines are. Sometimes you get really lucky and you can easily kill them, but sometimes you get unlucky. Get out next to this tree and snipe this guy up top. Get back in. And then you want to turn your Warthog really like this, so that it ends like this. And then throw frags at the Marines. And snipe them, or pistol them, whatever you like. Sometimes they go around this thing, but try not to do that yourself, because either they will be right here, or they will be right here, and try not to go like all the way around, and just stay here and either shoot them here and then walk over here and then shoot those guys and you can get back. Jump here and then look at your like what it says to press E, because it's really possible to get into the gunner seat and just wait until it says driver.
They're all dead. You didn't save them.
All right, for the final area, which is kind of weird, and I will explain that how it works. All right, let's make a course save just in case. All right, there's a couple of things I can tell about this. First off, we want to get a dropship, Covenant dropship, come out of there. And there's a few triggers we need to hit to get the dropship. First off, we need to hit the trigger that begins next to this tree. And you know you've hit it if Cortana says there are some marines hiding in the hills up on the structure. But if Cortana is talking like she did just now, or Foehammer is talking, she won't actually do that dialogue. And you won't start like the sequence of triggers that is needed to spawn the ship. So what you do is either way you get up to that up there, and you activate another trigger which is like starts up like here. And if she has set the dialogue over here, then a marine will come walking towards you, and you can splatter him, and then you can go back and kill things. If she hasn't set the dialogue, you still need to get over there and wait until she has set it, and then you can only then you can walk down. But it's faster if she has set it and then you kill the marine that is walking towards you. I think sometimes it's faster to do that, and sometimes it's faster to just walk down, because the next trigger to spawn the ship is to kill 8 out of the 14 enemies that are down here. So now when I get up here, there will be like no dialogue because I waited so long. And it depends on how fast you did the previous area. If you do it super fast, then you won't get bad dialogue, and you will get the "there are some marines" dialogue immediately there. And if you're a bit slow, then you won't get it, and Cortana will be talking. And if you're slower than that, then she won't be talking again, and this area will be fast again. But it's best to just show you what it looks like. Warning. I picked up reports that the Covenant. So now she's talking, and I won't get the immediate "there are some marines" here. The good news is the captain is still alive. So I need to wait here for a bit, and I can start killing guys already. Now she says the dialogue, and I can either choose to walk down immediately, or I can like look for the marine that starts walking towards me, kill him, and then go down here. Because if she has said that, I will call in, or if the marine is dead, that means like you sort of have talked to him, if that makes sense. At least to the game, it's like that. And then you can go on and kill 8 out of 14 enemies here, and then it will spawn the dropship. So let's do it again. Do it a little bit faster. Warning. I picked up reports that the Covenant has located and secured the Pillar of Autumn's crash site. The good news is the captain is still alive. The bad news is that the Covenant have captured the entire surviving command crew. Let's hurry and find the final lifeboat so we can link up with the rest of the survivors. Yeah, enemies aren't coming here, which is a bit unfortunate. Alright. And once I kill 8 out of the 14 of these, then the dropship will come down. There. Alright, let's save here. If you have frags, kill 3 of them, throw a frag, and then kill the grunts. And if he's alive, then kill him as well. If you have plasmas, it doesn't really matter, but it's just how I like to do it. If you have plasmas, then do it like this. Kill the elites, then throw the plasma, and then kill the grunts. Frags is faster, but if you don't have any frags, you know how to do it with plasmas.
Captain Keyes. He's being held on a Covenant cruiser.
And
the truth and reconciliation.
If Cortana says that's the last of them, then you know you've completed the level. If you've cleared that ship and she doesn't say that, that means either there's still an enemy alive in this area or you left a marine alive in the previous areas.
There's our ride.
Get busy to get into the ship and then just skip the cutscene.
The enemy has captured
Captain Keyes. Okay, so now we're on Tunar. And you can skip this cutscene. It's about 28 seconds. So you have to wait it out. And this level has a lot of combat, and therefore also a lot of RNG.
Once we get inside the ship, I should be able to lock on to the tracking signal from Captain Key's neural implants.
But I'll try to give you like the most common enemy patterns. Jump over these rocks, and the first part of TNR is just avoiding enemy blocks. For example, this guy can block you, and you don't really need to kill things here. Sometimes it's nice to kill the elites because the other enemies will just aggro or run away. This jump is kind of tricky that you don't hit your head on the branch. The only way you can actually die here is because of the upcoming elite. If this guy has a needler and you leave him alive and you get overcharged as well, that's the way you can die here. But otherwise, it's not a problem. Crouch jump on this rock. And make sure you don't crouch jump too early. Because otherwise, yeah, you can make it. But crouch jump, wait till you're stationary, and then crouch jump again to get up.
Cortana to Fireteam Charlie. Move up on the left. You should be able to flank the enemy.
Alright, now we got the part done where we don't want to get blocked. And I'm going to make a save. Alright, so the first thing what you want to do here is kill these elites. And then snipe the guy up top. And sometimes there's a grunt around here getting into the turret. You want to snipe him as well. And then what you want to do is kill 8 out of the 10 enemies that are here, including the two you might kill here, like the elite and the grunt. And you want to kill them before. Before you get to, you want to kill them after you get to this point. Like, you need to cross this, and then you can kill the last enemy. You can kill like 7 before, but the 8th enemy you want to kill after you cross this rock, because otherwise there will be a early wave coming in from the craft lift. So just make sure you're moving towards that rock, or past that rock, and killing enemies at the same time. So, and you can just first focus on the grunts, as many as you can, and then on the jackals. And counts, you can try to count how many you've killed. Like, there are 4 grunts down here, usually. And 2 jackals, so that's 6, plus the enemy up top and the elite up top is 7. And then the 8 that might be the grunt, you already killed down here. And if that's the case, then you must be careful with killing all these enemies, because you don't want to kill them before you are past this point. So you sometimes might have to wait for a bit until you're past here and then kill the last jackal or grunt that's down here. In my case, there are still 3 enemies alive. Usually they're in turrets, the remaining 3 enemies. Sometimes they can run around as well. But that grunt is from the previous area, I think. But if I kill this one, then she should get the dialogue and a dropship should spawn. And this dropship will drop down some grunts. So again, the elite and then grunts right there. Focus on grunts and then the jackals. And I saw this grunt running towards her, so I know this is the last grunt from all those enemies here. And that's why I know it was the 8th enemy, and then there's just two more to go. Snipe these grunts. And if there are one of these grunts remaining, one or less, then the dropship will start coming down, so be aware of that. Like, if you have trouble killing the final grunt and he's running away, then start worrying about the dropship. And for the next dropship to spawn, there must be one or less enemies remaining. So right now, like that, just notice how many you kill with your grenades. Also, if you run out of frags and you're gonna throw plasmas, then you should throw them a little bit earlier. Yeah, I didn't pay enough attention because there was one more. Also, what can be useful to know is that, let's see, that if you shoot on this graph lift, the waves will like insta spawn. I'll try to demonstrate it. Like, they come immediately down, so I throw early and then shoot. They sometimes come immediately down. And that was me being dumb because I should have thrown frag early. Not worry about this one jackal. Alright. If they're all dead, then you have like a few seconds to grab a plasma pistol and some frags. And then you want to get up here. And then you want to snipe or kill the hunters. And there are three types of like spawns for the hunters. That is, if I'm standing here, this is the easiest one. When they're both with their backs against you, you can, like, if you're quick, you can snipe them both into the orange and kill them in one shot. Three snipes in the blue will kill an elite, and three melees will kill an elite. Like this, I try to snipe that one and then kill or shoot him three times, and hopefully that three times will kill him, but sometimes I hit his shield and that one, yeah, then it doesn't do any damage, and so I melee for the last thing. This one's easy. And hopefully I can get the bad spawn as well. Yeah, this is the bad spawn, so we have to run around here and then shoot him from up close. And then try to snipe him and melee him. And then you can grab some frags if you need to, or the plasma pistol if you didn't get the chance to do that. Once we're inside the ship, mash enter. It's like 16 seconds if you after you've killed the hunters. Oh, that's not what I wanted. Does it work? No. Yeah, it does work. Okay. Save this. Walk back and look towards this pillar. And then the marines that spawns in front of you, if you kill him, that skips the dialogue. So look back and look towards this pillar, and one either spawns here or there. And then just snipe him. This one is a little bit hard because he like runs towards the right here. And the other one just walks forward, so it's easier to snipe. After that, just look around where your guy, invisible guy, spawns, and look while you shoot him, look on the radar where the next wave spawns. You need to kill 6 enemy waves here, and there's a couple of things you can do to make it easier to kill them. Right here, there was a really fast spawn because there's two kinds of doors. There's doors with like no room behind them, and the enemies come out fast, and these doors have like a hallway behind them and they take a little bit longer. So when I shoot him, I look on the radar, and I know when it's slow, I tend to walk towards the door and just don't use a frag. But if there are jackals, then frags are very useful to kill them. And if I see an elite on my radar, like a fast going red dot, then I might try to snipe him. But that's risky, because if you miss snipers, then that was really unfortunate, but frag would have worked if it like had gone well. Didn't get bounced off. And sometimes I don't throw frags for jackals like this, because they like run around and note. If they like pull up their shields, then it's useful to use a frag. What's also nice to know is that 3 shots from a plasma pistol will like get down an elite shield. For this part, I just overcharge my plasma pistol and shoot the one in the back. If he pulls up his shield before you shoot him, he's not dead and you will need to shoot him more. And after that, this door will open. You can grab a new plasma pistol. There's a couple things you can do here for this RNG room. The first strat you will do is get down here and bounce yourself off the rave so you won't take full damage. Then you overcharge the elite. And if you hit him in the front, he will do the, like this animation, and he will start following you. And I walk to the last door because the elite walks faster than me, so it's faster to get down here. What can also happen is that you don't overcharge him like the right way. If you hit him in the side or something, like now I just hit him in the front again and he will follow me, but I'm trying to do it wrong now and it doesn't work. Let's see, maybe if I hit him in the feet. No, he's still angry at me. Alright, so what's the case if he... Problem is, if I don't hit him right, he will like pull his shoulder back or something. He will do like another animation. And then you know like you didn't damage him enough or hit him in the wrong spot, and he will not follow you. So what you do then is go here, you shoot, and the elite should always walk towards this spot and open the door for you.
Wait, that's the locked door down there. The Marines
are like that. He pulls back his shoulder and he's not going to follow you. And if you stand here and just shoot, he will eventually always walk towards this spot and he opens the door for you. The final thing, if the elite dies for some reason, if he gets shot by an enemy and you accidentally overcharge him and then he dies, the final thing you can do is just kill enemies. But this is really like, if you're a good runner, then this is already a reset, but you can wait for enemies to, like if you kill enough here, then another wave will spawn, because this is actually a wave fight. And you can wait for enemies to open the door here.
Wait, that's the locked door down there. The Marines are waiting on the other side.
And now he does, he pulls his shoulder back and he's not gonna follow me. Now he spawns like here, but sometimes he can spawn all the way over there as well, so it's kind of tricky to to find him sometimes. And then this part is just avoid getting overcharged and losing health. It's not necessary to kill these enemies, but it's nice to get a checkpoint. before the nade step, which we're about to do. So you get the checkpoint right here. Look up, search for the elite, zoom in, kill him. And if you don't have enough frags, then you can grab frags here. Same goes for health. Right here, the nade stack. Throw plasma on this part of the pillar. Not this, because it will fall over there, and not there, because, well, should throw it like more here, because it will fall behind the shield. So in the middle, and about this height. This is too low, and this is really too high, so about this height. And the second plasma, we want to throw at the same time as the other plasma. Right now I did it too early and they explode weird. You want them to explode at the same time, like this, and we'll give a big boom. After that, you throw a frag at this, against this part. That's what I usually do.
Lock on to my signal and approach fast and low. There's a shuttle bay on the ship's starboard side.
Roger, Cortana. Echo 4. Now you can get up.
Lock on to my signal and approach fast and low. There's a shuttle bay on the ship's starboard side.
Roger, Cortana. Echo 4. What you can do, like, you can get up here and then throw a frag and get up here. Like this. It might be useful to crouch for this jump. I didn't this time, but it's easier to get up if you crouch. What you can also do is called the spirit jump. If your plasmas get down at the exact same time and they are really close to each other, you can do this. Otherwise, it's really hard. So let's try it. And stand right. You want to stand exactly on top of those plasmas and then jump as late as possible. And sometimes you will get high enough to get immediately onto the ship.
There's a shuttle bay on the ship's starboard side.
Roger, Cortana, Echo 419. And then crouch here. Like that. And it saves a bit of time. It also keeps some of your health. But it's risky to do, so I wouldn't recommend it in a full game. But it's sometimes, if you see that your plasmas are good, you can try for it.
Lock on to my signal and approach fast and low. There's a shuttle bay on the
ship's starboard
side. Otherwise,
just do this. Get up, throw a frag, crouch jump up here, and then you want to, like this area, and you want to throw a frag directly down, like I can't look any more down. So right now I throw the frag, and then I jump. That's the reason why I killed this elite, because he can shoot you, and if he shot me there, I would have died. Nope, not good enough.
Lock on to my signal and approach fast and low. There's a shuttle bay on the ship's starboard side.
Roger, Cortana. Echo 419 on approach.
Alright. And throw on directly down and just wait a little bit. I've been doing sometimes that I jump too early, but it's just a normal grenade jump. So wait a little bit before you jump. And then for this part, I tend to shoot all the elites first. Then look over here if there are any grunts. If there are not, then there are three grunts over here. Then I throw the plasma over here and kill the remaining three grunts. And that should open the door. If the plasma kills the jackal right here. If it doesn't, you still need to kill the jackal. What I see people do as well is kill grunts and elites, but I don't really know how to do that right. It can be fast as well, just as fast as the one I did, but I find it more consistent to snipe this guy than this guy. And then look over here if there are any guns. Sometimes there's one here and one behind there, and sometimes there are only one here. So If there are two grunts here, there's one grunt over here. If there are one grunt, if there's one grunt here, there are two grunts over here, and there is always three grunts over there. But now my position is always the same. If a grunt tries to hide behind this, throw a plasma right there and shoot this, and we all should die eventually. And then just walk there. And then just kill these guys. And you want to kill these guys, actually. It's not just for preventing them to block you. Usually I would have a plasma here and throw one right here, but now I don't, so I just shoot him. The plasma should just kill him if you have one. And hopefully you get the checkpoint here. Yeah. What I do for this area, I snipe these and shoot about right here. And then kill the remaining enemies like so. Like this. Maybe I can do it faster. Shoot here. I try to snipe these invisible elites as they, because they will always come to the same spot. And I use that to my advantage, but it's still hard to snipe them. Also, the grunts always run towards the middle. So if you snipe the elites correctly, then there's like three grunts like right here. It's really easy to kill them. If you don't want to do that, the more consistent way is just go up while they're not alerted and shoot those guys. And then just look for the grunts. And then this guy. Sometimes you get lucky and you can snipe the gold elite as like you're trying to snipe these guys, but sometimes you get lucky and you can collateral grunts as well and elites, because they're all like converging to this spot when you shoot there. After you've killed all of them, go hit this button. Sometimes I do it like this, I walk back and then press E. I'll do this one more time because I was late there. Alright. And then go here and grab your health and armor. Look back and snipe these two marines. And you don't need to kill those two, but at least one is good. But there's like, if you leave one alive, there's a 1 in 50 chance that he will kill keys. And it's not fun if it happens, but don't worry if you like kill one and then leave one alive. He will usually just die. For a frag to kill jackals. And I use only my plasma pistol here because it will kill enemies and alert keys at the same time, because your sniper is actually a like silent weapon and it doesn't alert enemies. And you can bounce your frag off here to kill those jackals. If you leave that elite alive, that invisible elite, the keys will be slower like this. He's not coming directly behind me. And just shoot here to alert these elites, and then when you kill them you can walk back and you can shoot keys and then mash enter if you get close to him. The level will end as well. Okay, this is SC or sound cartographer.
The Covenant believe that what they call the silent cartographer is somewhere under this island.
And the primary trick on this level is the fling to get through a door.
The island has multiple structures and installations. One of them contains the map room.
And I'll talk about how to make that consistently. But first we're gonna do a nice walk on the beach. I'll explain how to do Stickstack, which is another trick for this level, after I do the normal route. Right, you need to get into this warthog. And you can, first of all, just walk over here
into the interior of the island.
And spam E, and then look over here, and you can just drive away. You can also throw a frag to flip it, and you want to throw the frag right here, and want to look about right here while you throw it. So right here means like above this part, and you can use the ring, the halo ring, for reference. So it looks like this.
It looks like there is a path into the interior of the island.
Then you can just drive forward. But now I want to just do it the normal way. The frag saves like 1 second. If you're going to do stick stack, you don't use the frag. But for a normal stretch, it doesn't matter. For this part, you want to slow down a bit if you're next to this tree. So slow down a bit and then get up here. And drive the front of your warthog into this wall. And then into this wall. Then drive your left wheel up on this ledge, like this. Just by looking, you can do it by looking at the right time. And then keep looking like into the wall, so you stay up there. And then you slow down a little bit here, and then go further. So like this, look into the wall, slow down a little bit, and then turn around. Next up is the fling. I have a checkpoint for that.
Let's keep going inside.
Right, fling first off looks like this.
Don't let them lock the doors.
And
let's keep going inside.
What you want to do is, when you get up here, look around this area, like this part of the door, and press E when the front of your warthog is about this on this area. So let me mark that more precise, like over here. That's when you're where the front of your warthog needs to be when you press E.
Let's keep going inside. Don't let them lock the
doors. E, and then just turn. And you need to look like into the window. You need to turn quite a lot to make it.
Let's keep going inside. Don't let them lock the doors.
And if you press space at the end, dang, I missed it.
Let's keep going inside. Don't let them lock the doors.
Sometimes it is really unfortunate because your warthog like gets bumped, its back gets bumped. But if you go straight and if you have enough momentum, then you should be able to make it.
Don't let them lock the doors. Let's keep going inside.
Just you need to turn more if that happens, like your back gets flipped around. You can, after that, you can press space to jump over this elite after the fling. If you do stick stack, you need to kill him and grab his two plasmas, but right now we're not going to do that. We're just going to shoot here to skip the cutscene, and then we're here. Alright, to get down here, there's multiple ways. We can Hold down here and crouch here. That's like the most easy way. You can walk into this wall and crouch like this. That way is sometimes not as easy as I made it look there, but you can do it as well. Or you can, which is the fastest way, walk off like over here and then walk or look right here. And you're bouncing yourself off this ledge. And you can also do that like just move around and then just use your arrow keys to to position yourself, but that's kind of hard as you just saw. But it's fairly doable once you practice it enough. Right. Down here you need to grab this overshield to negate some fall damage. And if you crouch when you land on this, you can actually keep your momentum, because when you fall down you stop for a moment. And you want to walk off while crouching. And you stop for a moment and then you can continue, but if you hit the ledge of the crate just right, either you will do that or you can like crouch here again, and then sometimes you will get the overshield as well. Here you jump over this thing and then press E and enter at the same time. So jump and then E and enter. Like alternatively press them. And after that you want to kill these elites while they're over here. You just keep walking, but you try to kill some of the elites. The point of that is getting a plasma. Sometimes you're grunt over here and you can shoot him to get a plasma as well. And they jump up here. Then crouch up top, and usually while in this jump I switch to my plasmas. And then over here we can do the plasma jump. When we stand like this spot, we can plasma. Oh dang. We can throw plasma here. And get up here. You'll see that you keep a lot of your health when using the plasma. You can do this with a frag too, but you keep a lot of your health with the plasma, so even if you have lost a few bars, you can do this trick. I've even done it on 4 yellow. So yeah, you can lose a bit of health and still do this jump. If you don't have enough health, let's say you're on 1 red, then you go walk into this corner, jump up here, and then jump into this corner, and then jump again. I do it fast, looks like this. And right now I just want to use the plasma jump. And I crouch to get up here. Avoid enemies, sometimes there can be a lot of damage coming down there and you might want to walk around them. Sometimes there's some jackals here which you need to jump over. Now they're all over here. So that's a bit unfortunate. Let's see if I can still do this. This hunter may sometimes boost you. Like this. Usually he's a lot more over here and you can shoot around here and he will come towards you and he will boost you. But the thing is, if he's like turned around like this, you need to shoot and then he will turn around first and then comes walk towards you. So you want to shoot earlier the more he's turned away from you. So I shoot right here and then, well, that was horrible. If that doesn't happen, you can just walk over here. If he doesn't dump you. And the rest is just a bunch of platforming. Usually you still have some some camo here. Just walk around this guy and crouch jump over this. Usually there is another goal delete because I used the checkpoint, he is not there. But usually there's another goal delete standing right here, and you can jump over him and he will usually block this guy. And then you can just walk up. And if you hit this trigger, like if you hear those guys die, then the level will end in 39 seconds. There will be a pelican coming in. And you can get into the pelican. This one. Like this. And then you can mash enter at the end to end the level. But first, we are going to do the Stickstack setup.
Let's keep going inside.
For the Stickstack, the setup I use is, well, similar to what everyone else does, but it differs just a tiny bit, like, dang.
Let's keep going inside.
I'll talk about it when I get there. Grab these plasmas if you want to do Stickstack. Don't grab the overshield, just walk down and hold crouch here. Then hit this button and go back. And you want to position yourself right here. So yeah. Wait for a checkpoint. And the spots I look to throw, because if you know what this is, then you know which grenades to throw. But the spots I use are this one. Then this one, I use the left line of my aimer to hit the corner. Then you can see this is a little bit brighter than over here, and I look just above the bright part, and then I look around here. You can like draw a line from this corner like this, and use that to line up like this one. Then I look over here like this exact spot, and then like this, and all these spots work the best for me. In combination with like this setup, so hopefully I can get it first try. But basically what you need to know for this trick, as well as after these like positions to throw them, is you want to throw them like directly after one after the other. You don't need to wait except for that shooting three times to throw the plasma. Also the range for throwing the plasma is like from here to here, to because you want the plasma to stick you. You can still stick yourself when you're looking right here. So like this and like this. I think here you won't stick yourself anymore. No. But I think this one works better because I actually don't know why. But sticking yourself is random. Like when the plasma explodes, you get launched either upward or to the side a bit. That's pretty random. And what's also a bit random is the plasma, because you want this plasma to land on the overshield and bounce on the overshield like that. If it like gets straight down, then it will explode too early, and that's sometimes random as well.
Lock the doors, and we don't have enough firepower to get through.
Cortana to keys.
Go ahead, Cortana. Have you found the control center?
Like that, it will explode too early.
Lock the doors, and we don't have enough firepower to get through.
Cortana to keys.
Alright, I got up there. When you get up here, you just walk over here. And you complete the level as normal. Doing that stick stack saves 25 seconds if done perfectly. And if you don't, even if you don't get it, you can still get up this ledge sometimes, and it will be equally fast.
Lock the doors, and we don't have enough firepower to get through.
Cortana to keys.
Go ahead, Cortana. Have you found the control center?
Negative, Captain. The Covenant have impeded
our progress. I can still get up here.
We can't proceed unless we can disable this installation security system.
And then walk over here.
We're still en route to the objective.
And you can complete the level as normal. But there, a few enemies are gone now. Like the hunters up here. Oh, the hunters are still there, but there are no jackals like right here. Also, you don't have camo, so guy, people might be shooting here. But that's basically that's SC. All right. This is Aotcr, Assault on the Control Room. And again, you can skip this cutscene because you're coming in a Pelican. And basically all cutscenes where you come in with a Pelican, you can skip them. And just hold forward here. And then I shoot about right here to alert the, especially this red grunt coming around the corner, so he isn't like right here blocking me. These orange guns might block you more now by doing this, because usually these guns are right here and the guns still alive are around here. But killing orange guns is much easier than red ones. So I just shoot to lure the red grunt out and shoot him, and then shoot the orange guns. If you don't do it, it will look like this. It will stay back more and you will... It still works most of the time, but I just like doing it the other way. Shoot the glass. And just some movement you can practice. Make sure you don't get blocked. Alright, here starts the bridge fall, which consists of three falls to get all the way down here. First, if there's a grunt here, you can melee him, and you want to jump from this angle into the wall, and then look right, and then press W and A. Jump the wall, look right, press W and A. And A, like at the last second, to not slide off. Your angle must be right, because if you do it like this, you will jump too far and you won't make it. And if your angle is too small, then, well, this still works as well. But just be careful that you don't hit this ledge, and this ledge can like bump you outward. And that's not what you want.
Or if the designers wanted the
installation, so like this. And then press A. You don't want to land all the way down here either, because if you land all the way down here, then you might actually die. So you just want to land on this ledge where I'm standing now. Alright. Then the second fall, which is probably the hardest. You can jump from right here, just above or on this black spot. And you want to make sure that like this this is behind the black dot. So you jump from here, move around the wall and land on the black spot, which I did not do. Like this, move close around the wall, and then land on the black spot, just this one.
Roger that. Make it quick.
Or like the darker spot, this one. And you can see if I come down, I look to the wall or to the mountain and move forward. Be careful that you don't get too close to the wall, because you can, if you hit this, then you will die. So just move around the mountain. And if you jump too early, you will slide off. Or you won't slide off, apparently. Let's do that one more time. If you're too close to the wall, then you should slide off while doing this. Yeah. If you jump too late, you will die from the impact, usually. Even later, I guess. Nope, still alive. Alright, yeah. If you jump from like right here, then you will die. But if you jump from here and go towards the black spot, you should be able to make it. And then you can't jump here. There's like a line here, so you need to make sure you jump on this thing. And then for the third fall, I do this. I walk off just off this ledge, not here. You want to go off like you want to hit this and turn left. And then move like use A to move into the wall or into the mountain. Like this. If you walk too far, then you will die. Which is, you want to land right here, not there, here. And yeah, there you see I can die. So if that happens, if you think you're going too far, just let go of W and you can get down. If you end up too far here, you will die as well, I think. Like, you can do this and you will die. So make sure you hit this and just move into the mountain and slide it. And then you can move here. And here we can do some, use some grenade blasts to flip this ghost, which we're gonna use to get a little bit closer. What I do is I throw the frag, usually when this rock is about to be out of my screen while I'm looking up here. So like right now, like this. And I look right here for the first grenade, and the second grenade is like this. So and make sure your grenades are directly after one another, and the ghost will flip. The grenades are pretty precise, and sometimes, yeah, the first one was too late, so it didn't hit him. That should be good. That wasn't really good, actually. Let's do it one more time. Alright. Even if it lands like this, you can just flip it and continue. Then hold space here. Gonna make a checkpoint for this. And hold space here as well. hold space here, and for this fling, I try to approach from like this path, and when I'm like right here, I turn, and then immediately after that, I press E, and I turn quite a bit, like I look all the way back here when I do this. So, oh, I need to get out even earlier. Or start turning earlier. And notice that, like, my ghost changed direction a little bit when it came down. And that affects it as well. Like, this is a little bit harder. But what I see people do is like this, that the ghost doesn't hit them. That happens either because you got out too early, or you're not turning enough, or you're using like something like A or D. So this is what you want. And if you look all the way back, then it will turn enough that it will actually hit you. So make sure to turn a lot. Like, this is really not workable. Damn. Try this one more time. Like this, and then you can press E. This is a sharp corner. This one is pretty wide. Or you want to take them wide. Or just look at the button, press E, and look a little bit away. Sharp corner. This one's sharp as well, and this one is wide. Hold space here to not hit your ghost against the floor. The rocks, all the rocks you're seeing here are random, not that they really matters for the speedrun, but it's just interesting to know that these rocks are random each time you run it. Alright, for this part, if you want to do it fast, I suggest you look at my which buttons I use, because that's the most important thing here, like the usage of A and D. You press space here, and you can use back to level out your ghost. Get in here. And this was really bad, but to get up here. What I do, let's do that again, let's actually explain what I'm doing. I turn and use W and D and space. So I turn and use W, D and space, and now A and W. Space, then you can use back to level out your ghost. And the ghost is kind of slow at reacting to your inputs, so you want to press your inputs a little bit before you like make a corner or something. And then for, oh, I'm telling out, for this banshee, you just want to come aim like right here and get out and wait a little bit and then get in at the corner. The waiting is that you don't get into the ghost again. Press E when you're at the glass, look down a bit, and then you're in here. Jump over here, and there's a grenade jump you can do right here. It's better to throw that frag a little bit later than if you do it too early. If you do too early, then... Well, that's still on time. You won't make it, and you have to walk around, like here. And it will waste like 5 seconds. So, if you do it right, then you don't need to wait at all. You can crouch up here as well. Jump up here. And get in there. But it's better to throw it a little bit later than too early. You can optimize this a bit as well. I jump from around the just before the middle of the ramp, and then loop back and hold A, and then jump again and jump again. Like this, and crouch jump up here. It's a little bit awkward to do it like just getting up, so that's why I jump. And make sure you don't. You have enough room to walk before you jump. Make a jump off this ledge and sometimes do a crouch jump up here. Or like slide, crouch to slide jump there. All the things here save a minuscule amount of time, but there's not much to do in this level. Just enter to skip the tutorial. And here. Press E when you're next to the ramp. And then look to the right and press E to activate this. See, it was a little bit too early, but it still worked. And I was a bit too high. Same here, press E now. And turn your banshee so that you like fling or get launched towards the... dang, I can't press buttons. Towards the button. And here you can press E at the right moment. And be careful doing this because you can splatter yourself if you do that. Too late. Okay, this is 3 for 3 Guilty Spark. And this level is relatively easy compared to the rest of the levels. It has a few minor tricks.
The last transmission from the captain's dropship was from this area. That was
over. Right, first off, you want to look at this rock so that you can take the most optimal path. And gonna make a save right here. The most easy way to do this is go over here and get up this rock, jump up here, walk around the tree, the big tree, or this is not even a tree, just a rock, and then you'll be up here, and you can go inside the structure. The way you do the rock jump, because the rock jump is kind of difficult, I jump from this leaf, so that one over there. Like the first leaf of this bunch. And I jump from there and hold crouch and S. Jump and hold crouch and S. You hold them kind of late, not like super early when just after you jump. Because then you won't make it. So, like this. And because this rock is kind of weird, you can. Not really stand on all parts, and you want to stand on this higher part of the rock to make the jump up here. You can do a crouch jump. And then I usually walk a little bit upward and then jump up here. Because if you don't have enough momentum or you're not high enough, you can get what I just had, that you get stuck on this thing. And you want to like jump right here against this rock, and then you can move forward. Jump a couple of times here, and then you're up. What you can also do is you can do a plasma jump to get up there, and then continue to get up there somewhere. And that works like this. A crouch jump here. Slide a little bit there, and then you should be able to make that jump. I'll explain that later, but I'm first going to do this part of the jump. What I do is I look the right bottom part of my crosshair. I like hit the side of the cliff with like this, and then I walk forward until the water disappears on the bottom of my screen, and then I throw the plasma. Like now, and I walk up here and jump up here. And this last thing was a crouch jump, and that's the most safe because you need 4 bars to make another plasma jump on the other parts, on the upcoming part of the level. So you can do it with 3 bars, 5 bars is optimal, but 4 bars is the most usually you will get with this strat. I throw the plasma really low. You can throw it a little bit higher and jump like up there. And that's a little bit faster, but this is somewhat safer because if you miss this, the plasma is not close enough to hit you that much to lose all your health. So if you miss it and don't get up there, you can still do the normal path and not have to revert. So the fast way is you look a little bit higher up the ramp, is what I do, and you throw it a little bit later. And that wasn't very good. You can see I got like hit by the cliff, and now I'm on 3 bars, so you need to do this really fast as well. You don't need to get hit by the cliff. This part is somewhat lower than this here, so you can make that jump. That's how you do it a little bit faster. And let's see, for this part you can walk up here and you crouch like, or you jump like this spot, and you can make, if you crouch, you can make like a slide jump. And this part is the part where we just went to get up the rock and then get up here and get around this thing, which you can also do if you walk here and jump when you land on this part, because this part is the part where you can actually stand and jump, and then you're going to jump over there. So it works like this, and I missed it. Let's see, so that happens. You may want to go a little bit lower like this, like that. Yeah, that's what I've been doing wrong, because this you don't have much space to jump and walk here. So here you have much more space. So you just let yourself fall. You don't jump over there. You let yourself fall, and then you can immediately, if you hold jump, you can immediately jump. Because if you jump down here, you can't immediately jump again because there's just some sort of delay for jumping. So you just let yourself fall. Damn it. All right. Just do this right this time. Let yourself fall and jump. And that was too low, actually. Like that. And that skips just going around this round, this whole thing. It doesn't save that much time, but it saves a little bit. So if you're going, want to go really fast, then you can do that. Right, just walk into the structure. There's a small thing you can do here to speed things up. I didn't get checkpoint, so I'm going to get my own. There will be this lift coming up, and there, the button is over there. So what you will always do is like jump, and then you get up, and then you press E to get down. What you can also do is wait for a tiny bit and then jump off as late as you can. And you can actually, you saw the press E to activate the lift for a little bit. You can actually press E while it's still going up. And because the lift from here is a little bit slow, it takes like a little bit to go down. If you hit it before it actually comes all the way up, it will go down immediately again and save some time. But it's very tough to pull off because you can only just make it. Oh damn, I waited already. Wait here for a bit. And wait here. Jump off as late as possible. And try to hit it. At that time I didn't get far enough to hit it. And you have like a small time window to hit it as well. The waiting is because if I don't wait and I hit it, then it goes down much faster than you, and there's actually a chance that you can die by hitting the lift. You can only survive that by hitting it by falling on this ledge, and it will negate some of your fall damage and you will survive. But that's really tough to do, so I suggest just waiting a little bit and then try to jump it, and then you will always make it, and you will save some time if you can hit the button. And if not, it will just still go up, and you can hit the button after that. It only saves like maybe less than a second, but it's a speedrun. So once you activate the button, you want to walk in this corner. Hopefully I'll get a checkpoint. Yeah, and you want to fall off this ledge and get down here. If you want to move forward all the time, if you don't slide off that, let me try to demonstrate, you will die. So make sure you slide off this thing and then bounce off the shield and then shoot anything that's in your way. I'm going to continue like this. Right here I shoot to lure these jackals out. These jackals are usually in this hallway. There should be three of them. Yeah, there it is. There's mostly two on one side and one on the other side. It's random on what side the two are, but you want to go on the side where there's only one, because you can just melee him and then continue, and if there's two, they will usually block you. You can shoot here a bit to lure them out, but it doesn't always work. It rarely actually works. I got lucky here. But yeah, if you see a jackal just coming around this, go to the other way, because it's more likely that there's a jackal on the side where there's only one jackal on the side where there's already standing a jackal here. So yeah, this is kind of luck based, but it doesn't really matter that much. And you can shoot this jackal a little bit to open the door, to let him open the door for you. And then over here, we're going to do a plasma jump to get up there. It works like this. It doesn't work like that. And you can see you can still make that jump even for yellow, so that's why you can do the plasma jump at the beginning, but I'll show it with full bars because it's easier to demonstrate. What you want to do is throw the plasma at like when you cross this pillar, so right now. And after that you want to crouch jump up here, then jump again. And the timing from where you need to jump again, it's a little bit hard, but it takes some practice to get a feel for like when the plasma is going to explode. If you really want to, you can also just get up this crate and throw a frag at your feet. Works just as well, but it's a little bit slower. It's faster obviously to do this. And if you're, for example, on free bars, let's say, from the early plasma, then you can do quite some things to let yourself take less damage. You can throw the plasma further away. And you'll take less health damage. Dang. or no damage at all. That's the like tricky part, because you need to be just in the range of the plasma. Or you can just, yeah, throw it. Dang, I don't seem to be able to hit it. That time I didn't. Oh. Because you want to be stationary here first, and that's why I hold back and crouch while I do this. You can also do just crouch and then jump again. But you want to be stationary before you jump again. That's the tricky part, because you won't jump if you're not stationary on that rock. So you want to wait a little bit on, or the crate. All right. There's a health pack down here, and you can actually hold enter to skip this cutscene, which is rare. And then what I do for this, I stand one of these things, like the middle one, and aim right here, just to the right of the middle of the door. And what you want to do here, three of these doors will open, and popcorn flood will come out. And you can kill them fast by throwing a plasma or a grenade right in front of the door, and it will explode and kill most of the popcorn flood. And if enough of the popcorn flood are dead, then the next door will open, because if I shoot enough of these, then the next door will open. And it's always the same door. It's first this door, then that door, and then that door. So if you want to do it fast, then let's see. No, this is not the one, is it? Yes, it is. Right. Throw a plasma down here. And that will destroy most of them. And you see that the other door opens immediately. So, and that's why I look a little bit to the right, because your plasma goes, you throw the plasma a little bit to the left. And if we would look in the middle, it would still work, but it's like a bit of to the side. It actually does not really matter at all, but I just like to throw it in the middle. Then what you want to do, you want to stamp to right here and throw a frag looking at this. And it should get down just in front of the door when it's closed. So if you do it fast, it looks like this. Get here immediately and throw the frag. And it lands just in front of the door and will kill a lot of other flood. And you can then throw a frag down there and will kill the rest of the flood. And when this music starts, that means that that door will start opening. And that's the door you can escape from this room. So if you do it fast, you just throw a plasma here, wait a little bit after it explodes, you throw that frag, and you wait here and hope there's enough dead. Sometimes this can happen. If your frag wasn't good enough, then this will happen, and there will be still a lot of flood here, and you need to shoot them in order to open the next one. So that's why your frags and plasmas need to be very precise. Very precise, I said. It should kill all of them. And then this one. And just shoot a little bit out of from these last ones, so that you kill enough, then this door will open. Just spam fire to not get blocked. You can go at either left or right, it's the same when you get out of the room. And then this part is just a bunch of walking. Jump over here, and you can grab a shotgun here for some health if you need one. If you need some, but you just got a health pack, so you're probably on full health. And this time, instead of moving down here, we want to move down on the left side. Basically works the same way, except there's no shield, but there's a crate you can bounce off. Shoot him. And then here is the camo jump, which looks like this. To get from there to there, because the bridge doesn't really work that well. Let's see. Alright, so the tricky part for this jump is that you have to jump as late as possible from this part and then crouch to get up here. If you jump from from here, other than here, then you may, if you jump late enough, you can slide on that thing and be a little bit faster. Not like that. Also not like that. Actually, I did it the first time. Sometimes you can slide to the end of this thing and then jump off. Right now I was just walking all the time. Like that, you can slide off it and get to here and then jump. Another thing about this is that you can you fall a little bit down there and it's a bit tricky to walk on and even jump off. So you want to make sure you're at the end of this before you jump over here, because if you do it, if you jump from any other part, it might take your your jump input. If you jump from right here, well, that still worked, but you can bump into things and go airborne and you won't be able to jump. So just make sure you walk all the way to the end. To prevent that is just jump a little bit lower on the thing. There's actually, it's remarkable how good you can stand on the edge of this. And let's see. What I do is I hold crouch and sideways as well to keep up here. But if you hold sideways, then you can make that slide. It's a little bit safer, I think. I don't really know, but I just do it out of habit. Not that time, actually. Right, go to the left here. Jump over this. And I got a checkpoint, okay. For this, you want to bounce your head off this to jump over these things. And make sure you take a wide corner, because you otherwise you will still get blocked by these things. And slow down a little bit, so take a wide corner and then just jump. Dang. Same here. Alright, right here you can do a frag jump up here, and you can use the angle of this to make a little bit more height and get all the way up here. Like that. And you can just go over here. Let's say you have for some reason lost health up on this point, and you don't die. You can go up here. There's health pack and shotgun ammo, and you can jump up here and go the same way. Alright. Alright, for this part, you can activate the bridge and jump on it and throw a frag in the back to kill all these flood, or most of them, to prevent them from blocking you. And then you can activate this elevator. The sound for the elevator will sometimes drop because there's too many sounds or something. I don't know. Let's see. I think this one. No, not that one. What I want to show is that we recently found something new for the bridge that you can actually walk on it, even if it's not there yet. So you can activate the bridge and walk to like 1/3. If you walk any farther, you will still fall down. So activate the bridge, walk like 1/3, and jump. And then you can throw a frag in the back. It just skips waiting for the bridge to appear. Like right there. I wasn't sure I pressed it, but because there was no sound. But I did press it. Alright, you don't want to grab these health packs. You want to be on run 1 red, because if you are on 1 red, then the level will actually end faster. So even if you're on full bars, if you're on like 2 bars, you can grab the health pack and then grenade yourself to get to 1 bar. And then just take this path, because right now we want to spawn some sentinels over there. And if you spawn those sentinels, then the level will end in like 7-8 seconds. You can die here, I guess, but it's really rare. Right here, the sentinel should spawn. You can just hide and wait like 8 seconds. And then press enter to skip the cutscene. Alright, before we start the next level, I want to explain a trick, because it's a little hard to understand if I show it like in the first instance I do it in the game. So the trick is called flat bumping. It works like this. Hopefully he'll approach me. Alright, so what I just did there is, normally you would have to wait for this door to open. It's about 60 seconds on easy. And we can actually go through the door by using a flood, who is a reviver. And reviver floods are special in the sense that they get back up. I can shoot him once. If I wait for a bit, it will get back up. And what's interesting is that if you stand on top of him, he will actually bump you for a bit. And he will actually teleport you. And if you're close to a door, then he will teleport you into a door, which allows you to walk through the door. And that's what we use to our advantage. What's also necessary is that we stand in a specific spot in order for him to get into the right position, because we can only bump through the door if he's in the right position. Really cooperating right now. So I let him punch me, then I wait for him to turn around, and then I stand on top of his body and get inside the door and then jump through it. Right, for this door in particular, I use the ground to see where I need to stand. There's like this line, and like this part, this part is where you want to stand. Like this entire row or like line is good, so that's, he's in the right position, except for like this part where the door is different. You need to be between this and this part. So I look for a shape like this, and then I just stand right here. Then I turn around and I shoot him. And you want to stand in the middle of the flood, Let's see if I can. I can pause actually. After he's hit me. Right, you can see like at the side of his head there's like an angle or where his where the popcorn flood or something, like the tentacles get out of his neck or chest. That's where you want to stand under. And I can show you when a case there where it's not working if you don't stand in the right spot. Like let's say you stand over here. If you shoot him, then this is not gonna work because you don't, you get something like this. You don't get into the wall, into the door. Same thing if you stand too close. If you stand like here. Actually, this might still work. Yeah, that still works. Well, need to be even closer to the door. Like this, and then he will, then you're standing on his legs and he'll just, yeah, he'll just revive under the door and he won't bump you. So there's, it's kind of a big area where you can stand. Like I got it still when I was standing here, so it's like between this and this is where you can still get a bump and get through the door. Alright, let's talk about what you do when you get inside the door. Alright, once you're inside like this, you can move forward. You can jump over this thing. Don't crouch jump. If you crouch jump, you get stuck. You get outside the door. And from here, you want to get up to this thing. Thing right here, and you can do the back crouch jumping like that. And that crouch jump is actually pretty difficult. I'll try to do it wrong sometime and see how it turns out. And that was not in the middle of his body. You need to be in the middle of his body as well, and he was a bit far away. Sometimes the flood can be random and just jump at you. And they will get to the like to the side of you instead of right in front of you when they may hit you. Alright, if you don't do this crouch jump properly, let's say that, oh well, I still got it. Dang. Let's see if I can do it wrong. Like this, you can get stuck. I can't move forward here, and I can't move sideways. And I try to crouch here, and then I can make it. You have to wiggle around some. Usually crouching helps until you get back in the same position. If I move back here, I get into the initial position, and I can't move forward again, so I have to jump over this again. And what you can even do is, let's see. You see this like half circle thing? If you walk in front of it and crouch and then look right here and move sideways, you can actually teleport outside the door. So that's something you can do as well, but it's a bit risky because if you don't look at the right spot when you're doing that, then you can actually fall through the map or get stuck into the door. So, but you can do this, that as well. Yeah, I'll show it one more time, doing it fast, and then we'll continue on the level. Also, there's like a 40% chance that these guys will revive. So you need to look, you need to search for one. And we manipulate checkpoints to see, to look for a reviver, and then refer to the checkpoint and then use that reviver to bump through the door. So yeah, let's get the level started. Alright, you can press enter to skip the cutscene, and then you just move right here. And for this first door, there's like five doors. On this level, which you can bump through. There's also four floors, and the first hard thing about this level is just memorizing the where you need to go, because it's pretty similar, everything is pretty similar on this level and it looks the same. Sometimes there's a flood with a shotgun chasing you and he's really almost killing you, so you can shoot him if that's necessary. Shoot this guy. We want to thin out the flood for this next door because there will be a lot and we only need one to bump. Shoot him. Shoot anything that comes around this corner. Walk straight up this wall and then move sideways, and then there will almost always be a flood coming to you or two. Shoot him. Shoot him once actually, because that's when he will go down. Sometimes you get random things like that, like a carrier blowing you out, but this door saves 12 seconds. So it doesn't really matter much. Want to be in time for this though. I lost a little bit of time, so after you kill some things there and make sure you don't die, you can, let's see, yeah, you can walk against the door and get through it immediately as it opens. And besides the flood bumping, there really isn't much to this level. It's just, it's easy, so you won't die as easily. And it's just a bunch of walking. But for the first door, you see I got blown out by the carriers, and if I was faster, if I shot the first flood faster, the reviver, then I would have gotten through. Also pay attention to your pistol ammo, because you want to use your pistol to for revivers to get them down and revive again. One pistol shot will get them down. You can flood surf here. Just jump right before the first flood and hopefully him and his buddies will keep punching you to get you some height and speed. Be careful not to lose health here. You'll need it for the upcoming part, the upcoming flood. It's not necessary, but it makes it a lot easier. Alright, I'm gonna make a save here. Let's actually do. Do it like this. Alright, yeah, here is the second door bump. And there's a couple things you need to do. Again, it's just thinning out enemies and everything and just leave the flood that will revive alive and use him. First kill these three carriers, then get up here all the way and shoot these sentinels, because the sentinels will kill your reviver. Then go down here, line up, and pick one flood and shoot the rest. And hopefully he's a reviver. This one was, but he was too close to the door. I did not line up really properly. And, well, yeah, that happened. I'm gonna try to stay alive here and show you the where you need to stand on this. And then I will try, and again, using a different method. Alright. If you go through this door, make sure you get the health back. And you have full health going through this loop because we're going to do a grenade jump. Going to kill things here. Alright, now this is a bit more quiet. I can actually show where to line up. We use again like the things on the floor to line up. And it's, you can see these things. If you use the bottom line for it and pull that line all the way through, that's where you can stand to get a flood pump. It's actually a little bit below that as well. It's like from here to here or something. Something like this. But it also depends on whether a flood will attack you from straight ahead, or he will attack you from the side, and that alters his position a little bit. But generally, if you stand like right here on this line, then you will get a flood bomb. Or you can use like this thing, or this thing. And let's see. I think you can use, yeah, you can use the teleport which I showed you earlier. You can use that on this as well. It works the same way. It's like that part of the door is now right here. Use this and then crouch and then look at this part, because you're probably like right here if you're in the door. Look at this part and then move sideways and you will teleport like over there. All right, let's do that core load. Because there's a different method you can do to make this easier, but you will lose, it makes it harder in a way as well. You can throw a frag here and jump. And I should have skipped the sentinels, but they didn't. The sentinel spawn starts like at the end of this line. There's like an invisible box here, and if you go through that box and it, if the game detects you and when you're into that box, then it will spawn the sentinels, and it checks every second. So if you go through it really fast or don't go through it at all, it will skip the sentinels. So if you go over that box, then no sentinels will spawn. And this makes things a little bit easier because you don't have to kill the sentinels. And you can, it's a little bit easier to set up, but you can lose health because you need to grab the health back here. And so you can't use shields, lose shields. You line up and then make sure you don't lose a lot of shields, like I'm doing right now. It's easier to single out a flood, and unfortunately this one was the reviver. Let's try again. Nope, not a reviver. So it can be really, you can see that it's really random if you will get through the door and save time. After you get through the door, down here, I want to get through that door over there. Crouch jump up here. This part may feel kind of scary because you're like the ground is right there, but you can actually walk on these things. Jump up here, and the slide will get you all the way up. If you got the flood bomb, this door will be like slightly open, but now you have to wait a bit for it. Throw a frag and jump up there. Don't really need to crouch. Right, then jump into this hallway. I lost a bit of shields, but that's okay. Be careful to not get hit by all three carriers there, because three carriers will kill you on the run rate. You can take one hit or two hits, but three will kill you. Keep your pistol out here, because there's a rocket flood right here. And if you shoot the carriers with the pistol, it will usually blow the rocket flood up. Right there, it did, like, it blew himself up, but just to be safe. That was the second floor. We're now coming up on the third floor, and the third floor actually has two flood pumps. You may want to take a look at your grenade count here. And there's a plasma you can grab right here. It's always there. And plasmas are useful for the upcoming part. I want to have two. I already have four, but right, let's say you only have one right now. You can get some from these guys as well. And I don't kill these guys immediately because I want to not get a checkpoint here. I want to delay a checkpoint. And that's why I want to keep my enemies close to me. Or keep shooting or jumping to prevent a checkpoint. Right here I throw one of the plasmas to still keep the checkpoint from happening. When it explodes, I should get the checkpoint. Throw a plasma here. And then we are gonna try to bump through this door, and there's multiple ways to do it. There's like first we always kill this guy, and we want to use this elite flood to get through the door like this, and then you're in, you can jump through. That's one position. The other one, if he's right here. And what you want to do is take a pretty wide angle, especially for this flood, because if you approach him like this, he will turn around like this. And if you then shoot him, he won't be in the right spot. So take a big corner. For this guy, you want to be the middle. You see, you can see these black spots or darker lines. You want the head of the flood to be in the middle of this, and then shoot him. And then stand on the like little, the big circle on his head, and you will get into the door. For this flood, you want this line to be behind his head. So this line behind his head, and then you want to, you can see these darker ones, and you want to walk straight in the middle of this darker line, and like right there. Oh wait, right here, sorry. I'm going to die, probably. No, okay. Right here, where the the angle of the doors, and in the middle of this black one and this gray one is where you want to stand. This is again the middle. Stand on the big circle, and what I do is I move to the right and then jump sideways or like at an angle to get here. If you are here and you jump right here, you may not make this jump always because you're in a weird position or something. So I suggest if you get it, then move to the right and jump sideways and you will always get it. It's not the case right now, but sometimes it's really hard to make this jump and it will put you back in this spot again and again. Alright, let's say you don't get a reviver. Try this one. Alright, I can show you this once. Look in the middle here, and then you get bumped. And then the same thing applies. You just walk over here and sideways and crouch jump up here. That's my attention. Let's say he's not a reviver. Okay, what do we do now? We can walk here. And we can use that flood that just got exploded. I want him to die though, because he didn't die the first time. Alright, didn't get it. Line up here. And hopefully this guy will come and smack you and you can use him for flop pump. Like that. So that's like the backup flood. That doesn't work. Shot him twice, then he won't revive again. Wait for this guy. Shoot the carrier if he's not too close to this guy, and shoot him. Dang. He wasn't in the right spot. I need to be closer to the wall, apparently. So not right here, but more like here. This time he's in the revive, but this would have made it. And well, if you don't get a reviver, then you just grab the health back here and wait for the door to open. Okay. This part of kind of scary because there sometimes is a rocket flip coming around this corner. So what you can do is just strafe here and shoot him. If you strafe at like this distance because he comes around this corner, he will never be able to hit you. So just strafe here and shoot him. And if he's dead, you can move along. I try to kill some things here because if I get the door bump, I'm on one red and you can actually die here. But it's not likely. Alright. Shoot the carriers right here. And then shoot this carrier. And we're going to lure some flood in. Stop shooting once you get through here. Go around this corner and wait for a checkpoint. Got the checkpoint, then we move back. And we search this group of flood to look for a reviver. Alright, I didn't get any, so that's really unfortunate. But what you do once you get, let's say the last flood is a reviver, what you do is you kill all the other flood and lure him towards the door and then line up, and then if he's would be a driver you can jump through. Let's see, but if you realize there is no flood in there, then you can what you can do is just walk through after you've reverted and wait here. Actually, I'm going to save this checkpoint for a bit. I'll explain what you can also what you can also do is just not check for revivers and just lure on flood in. Just don't get that checkpoint and wait here and let all these guys come towards you and lure one flood in and get him through the door and just hope he's a reviver. And then you can do the same strat as I'm about to do now. If he's not a reviver, you can wait here anyway, because there's another flood you can use. You aren't a reviver. There will be flood coming out of these vents or something. Oh. And this guy will always come walking towards you. These first two will always stand just here and kill all these guys. You can use him if he's a reviver. But he's not, and that's your last resort. Other flood could come out of this. Will go down in one shot, but for some reason won't get back up. Like, this guy just doesn't want to get back up. He takes damage when falling down there, and it's really annoying because you think, oh, I got a reviver, but it's just, the game is just nope. So you can wait here, and the flood, it's like easy to fend them off. Alright. Also on that door you can use the teleport as well. Well, you don't really have to throw a frag there because it's easy, so you won't take that much damage. But if you can throw a frag before they get there, it's just nice because you won't get blocked. Right, the last floor. There's one bump on this. It's relatively easy to get. Well, not really. It's relatively easy to set up. Do I have full health? Yeah. If you don't have full health, you can grab that health back because you need it to do a frag jump here. If there's some guys falling down here, you might want to shoot them because. Let me do this. Well, I got checkpoint anyway. That's what you do. You get up here and get through here. And you throw the frag against this line, is what you try to do. And if a frag usually takes you to one health, so if you can also do it like this, there's a chance that these guys will shoot you and you will die because you're on one red and you're one shot away from death. So that's why we usually throw it like this. And it will take a little bit less damage, but it makes a huge difference because the enemies won't be able to kill you as fast. Dang. Threw too late. You want to throw the frag as soon as you jump on this thing. Maybe a little bit later, I guess. Well, it works as well. And then just crouch to make it up here. I shoot right here to lure any flood to come towards me, also the revivers, and I use this line to line up for a flood bomb. And if this happens, you just walk back a little bit and go back to this line. This guy wasn't a reviver, unfortunately. Maybe this, no, this one isn't either, I think. He can already get shot. Yeah, it's the one I just shot down here, he was a reviver. And it's really unfortunate because there's like two flood and you have to choose one because you can do one at a time and the other will just mess you up. It's annoying if you choose the wrong one. Yeah, he's too late. And this door is kind of tricky for the teleport thing. Here you just want to walk through. I usually throw a frag down there because I don't want these guys to hit me. Because I'm gonna do a frag jump, and there's quite a lot of enemies around me. A checkpoint is nice if you get it. And then walk a bit to the left. If you walk too close, if you walk straight through, then you might be able to bounce into a flood, and he will attack you, and if you're on one red with no shields, he will kill you. And then just walk here, and the level will end.
The energy barrier surrounding the apex will deactivate when we reach the ground floor.
And then this cutscene will take 63 seconds, and you can't skip it, so it's annoying, but a nice break, I guess.
You may now retrieve the index. Protocol requires that I take possession of the index for transport. Your organic form renders you vulnerable to infection. The index must not fall into the hands of the flood before we reach the control room and activate the installation. The flood
right.
is spreading. We
off to two betrayals. Okay, two betrayals. You can skip this cutscene, but after you skip it, you immediately want to walk left by pressing A.
Look out.
And then shoot one of these guys. And the main goal here is to just not take much shield damage. You can crouch to get through the door a little bit faster. Shoot two of these guys. And try to overcharge the elite. If you don't, then just shotgun him. And the reason we kill the elite is to scatter the grunts so they won't shoot at us, and we won't take as much damage.
We can't let the monitor activate Halo. We have to stop him. We have to destroy Halo. According to my analysis of the available data, I believe the best course
right.
of action is somewhat...
Here again, I try to take as little damage
size will help
as I can.
Stabilize the ring and will cut through a number of primary
I jump here to avoid some needles.
Trigger a detonation.
And I'm going to make a save right here. Alright, there's at this part there's two things you can do. You can do risky and jump from this spot up here and just slide down. Hold W and slide down. And
if I
would have pressed crouch, then I would not have taken so much damage. Jump from this spot. Jump really high up the ramp and crouch just before you land. And then you can uncrouch and jump to get some excess slide speed. The downside of doing this is that you will get a lot less checkpoints in the level, and in worst case scenario you can die and lose 3 minutes on this level, so that's why it's a bit risky, but it's like 10 seconds faster. If you don't want to do that, you can just slide down here, crouch, slide down these, crouch. If you hit these like slide things, then you will take less damage, and you can continue to get to the Banshee. This way you will not skip the box that gives you checkpoints later on at the level, the trigger box.
I'm going to search what's left of the Covenant battlement and see if I can
if this happens,
if the ship's
like you won't get
intact,
like you will hit this crate or something, then you need to jump higher up this thing.
If the ship's fusion reactors are still relatively intact,
and you're more likely to make it.
I'm going to search what's left of the Covenant battlement.
Keep forgetting to crouch at the right moment, so I'm taking a lot of damage.
We can use them to destroy Halo. I haven't located the
You can get hit by the Wraith here, but it doesn't really matter.
The monitor or his
Enter this thing and mash enter to skip that tutorial.
Without the index.
Gonna make
the machinery in these canyons are Halo's primary.
Save here. What you want to do looks
so,
like this.
Damage or destroy these generators, the monitor will need to repair them before Halo.
And you want this Banshee to fall into a nice position. This is not a nice position. You want it to be in a position where you can enter it immediately after you get out of here.
So, if we damage or destroy these generators, the monitor will need to repair them before Halo can be used.
Like this. Like, so I can get down here and enter immediately. So you do it by pressing E when the front of your Banshee is like here, E, and then you can slide against the wall, And then what I do, I press E here, and then I look down a bit. If you look down, the banshee is more likely to fall this way.
Damage or destroy these generators, the monitor will need to repair them.
And you can just shoot a grunt that is in your way. So make sure you have your shotgun out when you enter the banshee.
With a nav point, we need to move in and neutralize the device. Wait, that's the pulse. Commandeer one of those banshees. We'll need it to reach the pulse generator in time. Objective accomplished. The pulse generator has overloaded. Scanner. The generator's central core is offline. Well done.
Now you can enter. I'm gonna make a save here. What you want to do here, you want to get down here. And the banshee actually falls faster than it flies, so I let myself fall here. And get out, and then get in here. Also tricky is that if you like struggle a bit here, and you have to flip your banshee to get in, then you will be somewhat later for this, and grunts and stuff like that may already be coming out. But the real problem is if you're too fast. And if you do that, then the orange pointer won't have appeared yet. And if you're here too fast and you walk too fast through this, the orange pointer will still be here while you're walking through this. And that means you've missed a trigger. And missing a trigger on this level means that you can't complete it, so you have to hit every one of them, including this one. So if you're early here, just wait a little bit, and then you can move on. But now I'm a bit late. Well, not late, I'm like exactly on time, actually. And can I don't have to slow down or anything. I want to check one here as well. We can go really risky here and do this. Shoot him for a plasma. And try to get up there. It's really tough because I'm missing one health bar. But or it makes it tougher. But you can do it like this. And then get down here. As you can see, there's like multiple things shooting me and I'm on one bar. So it's pretty risky, and mostly I would only do this in IELTS, but sometimes I feel pretty risky and I do this in full game too. But if you're just starting out, you can easily, you don't even have to shoot that grunt, and you can just move over here, jump on this, crouch jump on this, and move down here. There's a trigger here as well that you need to hit. If you go through here, this part too fast, these jackals will not spawn. That again means you can't complete the level. Like the trigger ends like here. You need to be in the trigger box for 1 second at least. Or at the maximum, because it checks every second, and if you move through it in faster than a second through the trigger box, then you might be able to miss the trigger. And you don't want to do that, so make sure you... It's actually pretty hard to not hit it, so most of the time you'll be fine. But just in case you move too fast, like if you do this, you will almost always get it. But if you don't see any jackals here, you have to go back. You can like throw a plasma here to try to stick him or something. It's not really necessary. Can I get a checkpoint here? No. I won't get any checkpoints because I did the risky strat at the start to continue. Here you jump on this, jump on this, and then jump on this, or crouch jump on this. Dang. Jump on this, and crouch jump on this. Be careful that when you're jumping from here to here, and one of these flood hits you as you're trying to jump, then you will go airborne for a little bit if it hits you, and if you're airborne, then you can jump and it will drop your jump input and you will just move like this as you get back up, so be careful with that. But you can also, you can mostly also use one of these to, it will hit you as you go up here. But most of the time it's just, sometimes there's someone standing right here. It's easier to shoot a lot of them. But I try to shoot them as little as possible so that they're occupied by the elites. And then just go here. Try not to get blocked. Can crouch jump over this. These jackals form a bit of a threat if they overcharge you. But if you're on full health, they aren't much of a problem. If you feel like you get chased by the goalie like this, you can do that, but you can more easily just throw a plasma beam under your feet. And he will stop chasing you. Alright, this is like the first real hard part of this level. Or scary part, that is. There will be a rocket flood coming out of here, and he can, as you can see, easily kill you, even if you're on easy. So he spawns, he comes around the corner if all these three are dead or down. Like, even if they're down and get back up, he will still come around the corner. So once you kill them, these elites really don't matter too much, but they're just annoying. So once you get all of them down, start shooting your plasma pistol at the wall. This time he came out of the hallway really early. Sometimes you can, he isn't coming around the corner and you can shoot before that to stop him. Hopefully I'll be able to demonstrate that. He's coming around the corner really early right now. Yeah. But you can see, you can still get him. It's actually good that he comes around early, because if he comes around late, it's much harder to dodge his rocket leg. What I also want to say is that try to aim a bit here for the plasma pistol. Try not to like shoot over here, because if you shoot here, you might hit him while he's still like standing over here or something, and he will come around the corner really late. And if you're like standing here and he comes around the corner, you have like no space to dodge his rocket. And for dodging the rockets, it's easiest to strafe. I see people jump a lot, but the strafing is safer. I can easily just dodge his rocket. Alright, once you kill them, make sure you grab the rocket as well, because you're gonna need it. Can grab some health here. You can try to shoot these. If they all die, then you might get a checkpoint here. I can make one for myself. This is the second bridge. This is the most likely part to die in this level, because there is one Banshee and three Rocket Flood over here. And these Rocket Flood are most easily dealt with when you're like coming up on here and then throw a grenade here and one over there. And mostly some of them will still survive, like there are two still alive now. And you can just shoot them as well. For some reason, you shouldn't be so scared of the rocket guys. They aren't that eager to shoot you. Like, I can just shoot them and walk straight through. You don't have to be that scared of them. Just as long as you hit your shots, you're pretty safe. The Banshee is more dangerous, actually. And it's really luck dependent if... yeah, right there, I got splattered by the Banshee. And it's really luck dependent if he hits you or not. I think it helps if you don't jump on the bridge at all. But that's just... I don't really know. I don't know if it helps. Sometimes you can use these things to hide. If you see him coming on your radar, you can look on your radar and see where he comes from. But hiding is not... I've never experienced it as a better strat. Shoot the glass and shoot one of these guys. And these guys as well, to just make sure they don't block you. You can activate the elevator from the side like this. And there's a small little trick you can do here. I can set it up. First of all, the normal way is just to like go through the door. But there's a way to save like a second. It looks like this. And I didn't get it. Dang. And you like... It's nothing special, you just hold forward at the right moment. But you can see like these sections, I use these sections, these little light parts. And when, let's see, when the top of my screen is at this part, like the last section in the middle, then I move forward. Or when like the lights disappear from my screen. So there, that's how I use my lineup. And the last light section is at its middle part, but it's still really pretty precise. But even if you miss it, it's like you lose half a second or a second. All right. There are several ways to do this section. The most common way is this one. You throw a plasma there to kill those flood, and then throw a frag at your feet. Jump over here. If this guy comes around the corner, shoot him, because he can kill you if you ignore him, and just continue through here. Another way is to, if you don't want to take any health damage, use one of the flood to jump on in, and then crouch jump up here. That's the first time I jumped, so I didn't make it. You can make it while I was crouching, but crouching is just useful. Then as well, if you have used a nade and all the flutter that you can't use, you can do one of those methods, and you can just walk over here. And then get through over there. That's like a last resort method. The way I do it is a bit hard, but it's the fastest. It consists of throwing a plasma up there, and if I would have done it fast, that guy wouldn't have hit me. You have to pay close attention to what buttons I'm pressing there. First it's a jump like this. I jump forward and then hold crouch and S to get stationary. And then I jump again. It's a crouch jump actually, I think. Like this, is it? Let's see. I don't even know anymore. Yeah, it's a crouch jump like this. And while I do the first jump, I throw the plasma. And then I waited there, so I took much more damage. But the last jump is probably the hardest. I'm gonna kill you guys for a bit. All right, what you want to do is go to this corner, and then just before you hit the end, you want to press D and space. That's the way I do it. You can also just turn and press space, but I like to use D and space. And then once you have jumped, you can turn as well. Then, if you wait too long, then the plasma will explode, and you won't be able to make it. So it looks fast. There's one more method that I see people use, and it uses a frag. It basically, it's the same as what I do, but it uses a frag, and it's like this. But I like using the plasma because I use my frags elsewhere. Alright, if you do that slot, you don't have to worry about any flood there. They will never be there because you're more faster. See, I don't know if you got a checkpoint, so I'm just gonna make one. Right here, you can shoot behind this ghost and go flip. The easy way is to just, if you're like coming through here, zoom in before the door opens, okay, and then it's easier to line up. And here you can go through here, the space here for a bit, and then get some good movement, get through here. Or the more basic way is to just go here, space, or you can press space and S to level your ghost out. And what's also important to note is that the ghost is like not so fast to react. So if you get through here, I let go of W right about here, and I start pressing A to move like this. But I already have a lot of speed, and the ghost is kind of slow in reacting. So if I do that correctly, I won't crash into anything. And that's really unfortunate when that happens. So yeah, it's spinning a lot. This gap looks bigger than it is. Alright. If you have 4 bars or even 3 bars, you can ignore everything that's here and continue. If you want to have more health, you can easily just stop here and grab some health and ammunition. But it's not necessary if you have still 3 more rockets, 2 grenades, and at least 2 bars of health. If you have 1 bar, then I'd suggest to grab the health back. This banshee exit is basically the same as the first one. Press E right here, and then walk through. You will always get a checkpoint here, fortunately, even if you do the arch threat in the beginning. Throw a frag down here. Let the thing hit you. And let me actually do that right. Alright, first frag here. And then throw a frag just before it opens in the back and shoot the wall. And then just shotgun these guys. The way you do that is because there is one rocket flood in this whole bunch of flood. And he can actually kill you, the rest really doesn't matter, but the way you clear this, make sure that wherever the rocket flood is, you will kill him either way.
That did it. The pulse generator overloaded.
The frag is for when he's in the back, and the rocket is for when he's standing like right here. Grab a new banshee. And again, the ghost or the banshee falls faster than it flies, so we do this, we let it fall here. And we want to enter this cave really high, like against the ceiling. So if you do it that way, then the banshees in the previous area won't follow you if you hug to the ceiling. Right here you can enter this ghost like this. But there's a danger, as you can see. Most easy way is to just do it like this. And yeah, make sure you don't do this from a high altitude, because you will take some damage if you fall. Like, you can't do this, you will take a lot of damage. So make sure you at the ground here and then do it like this. Also, I think you shouldn't like exit too late as well. Sometimes you can get splattered or something, I believe, by the ghost. I don't really know. Alright, use rocket flood. They are pretty easily avoided. The main thing you want to remember is that you want to go fast in this occasion. Don't slow down at all. Going fast is the easiest way to avoid these guys, because if you go really fast, they can never hit you. Except for when you life drive straight at them. But even at a really small angle, they will still miss you. Like this, I can go here and they will not hit me. But there he was, like, turned around, so he wasn't gonna hit me anyway. If you see him walk around this corner, you can just go here and move around him like this. I wouldn't try to shoot them or anything. You can easily avoid them by just going fast. Like this. Let's make a checkpoint here. I didn't see me get one. All right. Wait really close to the door and you can let yourself through. If you're too close, that can happen. You won't have enough speed and some guy might be blocking you or something to get in. So like this here is like the best distance. You have enough speed to get in, but if you're too far, like, you can't see the entrance and it's really random to whether you will make it or not. Keep your rocket out when you enter this ghost. So get in and make sure you're all the way, like, not like this, make sure you're all the way to the left, make sure you're like in the door. Get out, jump, and shoot a rocket at the back of the ghost. Or like behind it. And if you wait, it's kind of harder to shoot it to get it in the door, but it's still possible if you shoot it like right here. Not directly behind it, but more like over here. But yeah, even still, it's much easier to shoot the rocket just after you wedged it in. Like this. And it doesn't really matter where you shoot it, it will always like get stuck. You can shoot another rocket and get in. You need to hit two triggers here. So let go for, you need to wait right here, and you need to wait right here. And the fast way to do this is just let go of W for a second when you're at that part. So like this. Or maybe 2 seconds. If a guy comes around the corner here, then you will know you will have the second trigger. And if these popcorn floods spawn, you will know you will have the first trigger as well. If I go through too fast, well, they still spawn, but if you go through too fast, you might not spawn them. All right, this time it will, but trust me when I say you can miss that. And get out here. Activate this. The problem with this can be that you don't hear this button. More likely than not, you will have press it even if you don't hear it. So even if you don't hear it, just continue. Space E and move sideways to like make this a little bit faster. I move sideways too much and I end up here, but if I do it the right amount, I end up just in front of this button. What you want to do here, space and DNW, get out and stay next to your ghost like this. Throw a frag, shoot a rocket, make sure you kill 5 flood in this area. You can kill 4 of them and maybe one over here, but make sure when you get out of here, you have killed 5 enemies, or 5 flood, I should say, not 5 enemies. This time they were really nicely together, but sometimes they are a bit farther away and it's harder to kill them. And this time I have rocket ammo and frag, so it's really easy to kill them. Sometimes you only have plasmas and it's harder. Like this, I can choose to shoot him, or I can choose to get in immediately and shoot one of these guys. So if I do it fast, then it will look like this is a really bad spot. There are 3 lives I'm gonna try. You can use the carrier to blow other people up, or other flood up. Then you can just continue here. And if there are enemies in this area, then you'll know you've killed enough flood in the previous area. Follow this path. And press space here. And then for this ghost banshee transition, which is a little bit weird because you will think you will slide a lot, but you will just not slide at all and you will have to walk all the way. So make sure you get out pretty late. Like this. If you get up too late, then that happens, obviously. But yeah, just get out a little later than normal, and then just follow this path. It's the most straight path to the objective. Go under this thing and make this corner. Fast way, if you have enough health, you can get out like this. Just press E and hit yourself against this this thing. If you don't have enough health, you can do this. Make sure you don't get too far. Obviously, you can slow down a bit if you want, but you can hit your banshee against this so it doesn't. If you do it like this, the banshee may sometimes block you or something. Again, in a way, like if you do it like this, then well, that's not good. Do it like this and then slow down for a bit. Okay, maybe that's not the safest strat. But you can, yeah, also do this. Just fly through and get the health back. And don't be afraid to shoot sentinels there, because you won't take that much damage and they just got in the way. And then activate this.
Final target,
and move to a safe distance and start mashing enter.
The Covenant network is absolute chaos.
Let's get this cutscene. And first off, I'm going to show you a strat on this level that's not the most common. It's the fastest, but you should know it. It's shooting this grunt and just moving back, luring this flood to a certain spot. And what you want to do is line up with a specific spot. And then I jump over him and shoot him. And if he's a reviver, which he is right now, you can crouch on his head, and if you do it right, then you can get through this barrier. Yeah, this is the right spot. Alright, and then you can crouch jump over this, and there's a trigger here, so you walk in here and then go back, and let's see. Let me just save this for all. Alright, the spot where you need to stand. The way I use, like, you can see these sections. And for the third section, I walk against the middle, like this thing. That's where I stand. And you can see that's also where the fifth line is from, like this part, and you have like 1, 2, 3, 4, fifth line. Look right here. It's about the same. I like to line up like this. And if I'm here, what I do is I jump over the flood and I move through this position. Make sure like it's not like this, but really like this. Like you're just standing on him. If I move any further back, then I fall down. So stand right here. Then like this. And then crouch on his head. Make sure you're not moving. And then you can crouch jump over. Alright, then the normal strat, which is the shield bump. And there's quite some things you can learn about shield bump to make it better. First you throw a frag here to clear out these three grunts that are here. And then you either shoot or throw a frag or whatever to clear out the remaining enemies. There are like free flood over here, and I need this guy, come back. Alright, then what we're gonna do, we're going to use this guy. You don't want to kill this guy yet, because if we kill him, we get a checkpoint, and we want the checkpoint at a certain moment. So also I should note that if you throw a frag down there and it lands behind the carrier will come flying towards you and it will kill this guy probably, so be careful with throwing your frag, throw it like around there if you throw a frag. Sometimes the carrier waits and doesn't come around the corner and stands like right there, and only the combat forms come. And you can just shoot the combat forms and then throw a frag like there, and it should kill the carrier that's in around the corner. Alright, then we're going to stand on the shield. And I use the flashlight to have some light. And we want to line up on a certain spot. And the most, like, roughly, I use the, let's see, I use the, my crosshair consists of three triangles, and that's not good. I want that checkpoint to be somewhere else. Alright, let's do this again. My crosshair consists of three triangles, and I use the top left angle of it.
I've lost him.
Top left corner of the top triangle to aim and to line up. And roughly, I want to put it. You're still alive. You're still alive. Okay, roughly I want to put it in this corner. And so what I do is I first line up like this and get it roughly in that corner. And then I line up with this, I use this bar. I want this bar to not be jagged. I don't know if you can see it, but like this, it's still a bit jagged. Yeah, like this. And once you're in that rough position, also your vertical position doesn't really matter. So even if it's the horizontal position that matters. And after 7 seconds, the shield will come back up and it will like bump you as you saw there. And if you're standing in the correct spot, it will bump you to a spot so that you can go to the end of the level, actually. And I sort of first demonstrated how it just looks. It's still, yeah, it should be good. And I should get a checkpoint. Yeah. And then I get bumped. And right now I'm not completely at the right spot. I want to get up this thing. So I adjust a little bit. That was not a little bit. And I'm over here. And from right here I can get up here and jump backwards and end up here. And this is where you want to end up in the final, after doing that. So yeah, the problem right now is that I'm not in the exact right spot. And the easiest way to like alter your position is to turn a bit and then move the slightest bit forward, which is like this distance, this distance. If you press it too or too long, you will do like a bigger distance, which is like 3 times that distance. But this is the sort of distance that you want. And you can see the more you turn, the bigger your horizontal distance you will travel if you move forward. So if I do it like this, then I'll be a lot more to the right than when I just turn a little bit and move forward. So yeah, what I can show you is that like if you're too much to the right, which is about here, which is too much to the right, is when you're the thing I used to line up the top left part of my top triangle is at this corner exactly, then you're just too much to the right. This will not bump me, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, it will. That means if you get bumped to like the right, you're too much. Yeah, you're too much to the right. And I believe this is too much to the left, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, I also get bumped to the right, but if you don't get a bump at all, so it's your bumping positions are between here and here. It's a really small part. But for the let's see, for the bump positions that you get, I've made a graph. And what it says is, this is your horizontal position on the shield, which matters for what bump you get. And this is the height of the y-axis is like the height of the bump. Everything above the green line is a bump that you can use to continue. Everything below, everything that's red, you can't continue and you have to retry the bump. The first thing you should notice is that if you get a bump but it's not good, you're in the red area. And if you move right, you always move toward a green area, whether you are here or whether you are here. So if you get a bump but you're quite not there yet, always move to the right a little bit. So just turn a bit right and then move the slightest bit forward. And turn more to the right. Depending on how far you need to move. Like if you're, for example, right here, if you're really low, then you need to move more to the right to get it. What you can also see is that there are two parts. Like the positions will repeat itself. You get to the highest point, and if you move just a bit to the right, you will end up with not getting a bump. So yeah, this is from that little part I just shown where you can get bumps. This is how the different bumps that you can get were. And the points I made are like the easy, like the circle and the green circles, the green dots, are like the points where you don't even have to move or have to move really slightly to get to a spot. Because even if you get bumped, you still have to like move to a right spot where you can stand. And on the green dots there, you don't have to move at all. And it will show you where those green dots are. So back to the game. So let's see. Okay, I will move slightly. This is the easiest position to get to. If you get in between there, just wiggle A and D and you will teleport upward and you can fall on this part. You can stand like, you can see where you are, but you can stand on this. You can also fall down here and then crouch back up this. And if you're standing right here, then look towards this spot and jump back. And you can use this to know where you're standing. Basically, you're standing on something like this, but then for this hallway. And then you want to look right here, move a bit forward, and then hold space and backwards. And if you don't do it right, then you fall down. So right there, I had to look more to the left. Here, use this to know where you are. So probably like you can stand on a lot of spots, but it's right here. I think this will be right, so just hold space you can get here. That's too much. Let's see, still too much. Well, but it will for certainly be too much. This is good, I think. No, it's still too much. Yeah, you can like get over here and land here. Like this. Dang. Dang it, I can't get it. This is actually the this one, get it? No. This is actually the fastest way, because you can walk down here, jump up here, and then do this. Just walk backwards. And also one more spot I should show you is you can stand right on this thing. This is also a spot you should know where you can stand. You can stand here, you will fall down. Well, actually, you can stand here. Well, I did not know that. You can like walk on this. But if you fall down right on this like corner, then you can stand there as well. And usually I move back up here and then from here try to fall down here. And that's basically all there is to this level. Because after that, it's pretty simple. Just move over here. If you took any fall damage, you can grab the health back there. And now we're back at where we... This is where you come from if you do the flood pump. You get the trigger here. And all these guys will have spawned. And you can shoot him to get a shotgun if you don't have any. And these guys, just don't bother with them. If I would have jumped later, I would have made that. And then you get into the trigger for the cutscene, and you can't skip this cutscene. And you can see that the enemies are actually shooting me, and they will probably kill me in this cutscene. But that doesn't matter.
No human life signs detected. The captain, he's one of them. We can't let the flood get off this ring. You know what he'd expect. What he'd want us to do.
Will they actually kill? Yeah, okay.
It's done. I have the code. We should go.
Right.
We need to get back.
I will make a checkpoint here. What you can do is throw a grenade like this, and sometimes it will distract these guys, but as you can see, there are plasmas on the ground there, so it's kind of dangerous. And on easy, you don't really have to do that. You can just do this. If you take a lot of damage, then you can grab a health breaker. And then you can just go here. And here you can either, if you're really low on shields or health, you can go down here and then crouch. If you don't crouch, you will take some damage, or you can just go YOLO down here and fall down here. Going right out of here and then this way might be 0.1 second faster or something. It doesn't really matter. I usually just take this one just to be safe, but yeah, that can happen as well if you don't do it right. So make sure you move like this and crouch. You don't have to do this, what I'm doing now. It's just waiting for a banshee to come. Damn, he didn't do it. You can wait under this and then press E. If you wait too long, the banshee will fall down on you and splatter you, but that shouldn't really happen. Oh yeah, this banshee can go through walls and shit. And you also can skip this cutscene. Alright, press enter to skip the cutscene.
To get to the bridge.
Switch to frags.
We can use the captain's neural implants to initiate an
and
the
on the mall there are.
The explosion should damage enough systems to
press down
to
here.
Destroy the ring.
On mall there are a couple of different rounds at some points. A frag here. If the shotgun flood comes around the corner first, you just hold E to grab the shotgun. So if you, even if you see him and you can't grab anything yet, if he comes around the corner, just hold E and you will grab the shotgun. Otherwise, try to pick one up here. It's not really necessary, but it's just useful. And very useful for the other route here, which you go through there, but now you just go through here. Shoot this guy. And switch to plasmas. Don't grab this one yet.
The bridge.
Stick this guy.
Let's get to work.
Shoot him. Shoot him. Alright. That's why you don't grab
the
health pack yet. Stand here and mesh enter to skip the cutscene. Don't stand all the way here. You need to stand like behind this line over here. But yeah, the elite can chase you and then take a lot of your health, so now it's a nice time to grab the health back. Shotgun your way through here. Right, and then we're at this point. And right here I'm going to load a checkpoint. Let's see. And I'm going to explain Maw Bump, which is a different way to get to the point we just got. And it can be 20 seconds faster, but it's really tough to pull off. And if you miss it, it's probably time loss maybe by either 10 seconds. But it can also be, if you don't get a checkpoint where I am right now, it can be like a 40 seconds time loss, because you get all the way back to the beginning of the level. Alright, so basically it looks like this. If I can get it first try. I'll explain all these things I'm doing right in a moment. Here, go through this hallway, and it just keeps going all the way to the bridge, and you're back here again. Alright, so let's see. First thing is, you want to get like up this door, and the way we do that is we stand here to there is a trigger which goes from like here to over there. There's like a box here, and if you walk into that box right here, these doors will start opening, and you have to be it'll check every second if you're in that box. So sometimes if you go to it fast, too fast, the door won't open. So sometimes you'll notice when you go for this too fast, you will see a closed door, and then you have to go back and go in here for a bit, and then you can go back. I approach this and wait for the door to get to be open all the way, so I don't get blocked by the door going through it, and it just saves. It makes me get more on time. For the door, because it can be so that you're too late for this door, and if you're too late, you won't get up here, but you might fall through the floor, or you get bumped away or something. It's not good either way, so you want to be pretty fast. Go down here. Walk down here as fast as you can. And right here, you can see the door is not opening, so I go here. And then I crouch here, and I don't move at all. I want to crouch all the way in this corner, and I don't want to move at all. And then you can get bumped to two different spots. This is one of them. Let me actually make a save of this bump. Okay, crouch all the way through doing this, and you want to look here and press backwards and space at the same time and hold them both. And then let go of space and keep holding S until you're like stuck in this corner. Then look over here. Yes, yeah, like this. And then jump sideways. And then you should not be jumping again. Okay. I can't see anything right now. Okay. I should be good. Yeah. All right. So we want to look over here. Jump twice. And then you get stuck in this position. Look over here. And then what we want to do, we want to get visual in this room, but we don't want our real body to be in there, and we can do that by looking over here. And if you move, you can see the black line from the this thing. You can see that appearing, and if this appears, we can shoot. And shooting will shake our camera, and which will get us visual into the room. After that, I'm still holding crouch, by the way, all this time. And this visual is not the only one. Sometimes you have to move a bit further until like everything of that is shown, but we might get to see that later. If you're here, then, well, yeah, I just walked out of it. So don't move sideways. Crouch. Get back here and again. Yeah, like this. This is also where if you shoot, this can sometimes, back there was just a tiny bit of this was visible, and now like this is another spot, and those are the two spots, and you can check for the first one, and if that one doesn't get it, you can move a bit more to the left, and I'm moving left into a wall so that I'm moving only slightly towards this room to like lower my speed. And yeah, sometimes an explosion will shake your camera and get you visual into this room as well, but I could have also used my shotgun to shake my camera. Then you can crouch jump forwards and get on this thing. And what I do is I move a bit to the right, and then uncrouch, and then jump over to here, and I missed. Alright. The sound is gone, by the way, but that's supposed to be in the case for when you're doing this, or at least when you go back to a checkpoint like this. All right, you jump on this, and you can like see what it is, kind of. It's really not that big what you're standing on, but you can use it. And we want to go over there, and it's like a light which goes from here to here, but it's over there as well. We can see like one side of it, and we want to jump all the way at the end of this thing. So we want to run and jump and then crouch and then move back a bit. What we're going to do then is jump on that thing and hold jump the entire time and let go of W for a bit so that we have like a bit of a runway on this light. Let me actually make a save here. in case it goes wrong. We jump. And this time I didn't get really far, so I didn't have to let go of W. But make sure you have your, like, a runway and just hold space the entire time, because if I get too far, I will just walk off and I won't have enough runway to make another jump. Say you get stuck on this, you don't, you're not going to jump immediately, then you can also just do that. And be careful, because the ending parts of this, you have to jump a little bit before that, because you will actually get bumped up if you walk off of this. So you have to jump a little bit before the end of the light. And crouch on here, and this is like the same thing as we got on first. From over here as well. You can use these like benches to see where you need to land. Like the side of the bench, is it? Yeah, and then we can jump on this one. And from here we can jump in this hole. We can make it onto here. All right, hopefully I can get the other bump as well. Because that bump is, you get that bump if you're completely in the corner. And if you're not completely in the corner, you may get another bump, which is this one. And you'll notice that it's a bit different. You were standing right here on the other bump, and right now we're standing like here. And we can do something else. We can look over here. And first we do the same as the other bump. We jump backwards twice. And we let go of, we don't move all the way back. We let go of S and spacebar when we get down. And then we look over here and start moving to the left until we hit the wall. If we hit the wall, then we look over here and we use the same method to know where we are. And I see that thing appear and I shoot to get visual. Then get up on this thing again. You can use crouch if you don't think you're gonna make it. Crouch on this. Crouch, jump here, and well, that was really lucky that I, because I didn't even jump, but right, and then you get back here again. All right, if you don't take too much damage here, if you don't get hit by the flood or the sentinels, you can go here and do a frag jump right here, like this. But yeah, if you get hit by anything, you will die. Where am I? Okay, I'm here. So you can try to avoid some fire from these sentinels, and then if you don't get hit by those and don't get hit by these sentinels, then I got hit, so I won't recharge in time. If you don't get hit by the flood and these sentinels, then you'll recharge in time. You can do a frag jump right here. You can grab health and frags again here. Alright, I forgot to explain something here. Namely, the normal way you do this when not doing the frag jump. Just go over here. And you walk up to this, look back, and do a crouch jump up here. And then you can grab health and frags. Alright, grab the rocket launcher. Some, usually it's down here, but sometimes it gets blown away and it might even get stuck up here or somewhere else. And it might even get fly back all the way here or something. These guys will spawn, keep spawning for some reason. So just walk through it fast. And okay. 1, 2. So there's an overshield here, and you can grab that and do another strat. And the strat you can do with the overshield saves like 13 seconds, but going for the overshield loses 5, so in total it saves 8. But first I will show what to do if you don't go for that strat, then just then you would just clear this or just move through this and just hope that you don't take damage, because you don't, you need all your health then if you're gonna do this. So go through. Sometimes this grunt might block you. Let's make a save here. Walk up to this guy, shoot him, jump over these guys, and shoot these guys. And you should get through with too much, without too much damage. The hunters are usually busy with the popcorn flood or the sentinels, so they won't shoot at you. Sometimes they will, and that's really unfortunate. Yeah, that's how you do it. Also, what I should mention, if you want more rockets, there's an armory right here, and you can grab some rockets. But I'm gonna, I have enough frags. Frags are also useful here. Alright, first we're gonna do a grenade jump up here. And then we can grab some health.
Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access.
There's no health back there, should be. Okay, whatever. Alright.
Engine room located.
So frag jump up here.
Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining
you go up here
is to detonate the ship's fusion
and you
reactor.
Crouch jump on this and make sure you're standing here, not all the way here, because if you're standing here you will bump off of this thing, so make sure you're here.
First,
and then
pull back the exhaust coupling.
Crouch jump up this,
expose a shaft that leads to the primary,
activate this one.
Good.
And
step one complete.
Activate this one. And you can destroy these things. I'm still going to repeat this.
We're here. Alert! The monitor has disabled all command access. We can't restart the countdown. The only remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors. That should do enough damage to destroy Halo. Don't worry, I have access to all of the reactor schematics and procedures.
Hit that one.
I'll walk you through it.
And wait for the orange pointer to appear before you hit the second button. Then jump on this, fire your rocket in there, and throw a frag or a rocket. Funny enough, a frag will always destroy it. If it's closed or open, it doesn't matter. If the frag is down here, it will always destroy it. And a rocket on a closed shaft will destroy it. But not a rocket that's like, if you hit one of the shafts when it's like closing, then it won't explode if you hit it with a rocket. But if it's fully closed, then it will explode. So you can shoot a rocket in here and then throw a frag down there. If you throw a frag and you're crouched, then you will stay crouched for a little while. So you stand up a little bit later. Hit these two. And that one's closed, but it will still explode. I can throw a frag down there. So yeah, before I move on, I have another save. Let's say I grabbed the overshield and I lost a bit of overshield during the hunter part and such, but you can do another strat that looks like this.
Engine room located. We're here.
Wait, that's legendary strats, never mind. Looks like this. Throw a frag. And if you throw that frag early and against the wall, you won't lose all your shields. Because if I throw it like this, you can see I will lose more shields, and if I throw it against the wall like this, it will be further away and I won't take that much damage, which is very useful. But if you throw it like too far, then you won't it won't hit you. So
engine room located
like this.
Over here.
Then stand about here, like this part.
Alert.
Stand
the monitor has disabled all command access. We
throw,
can't restart the
shoot the rocket and jump at the same time.
Remaining option is to detonate the ship's fusion reactors.
And then press A and W to get up here. You need to do this fast as well, by the way. You don't have much time to line up. And it's pretty dangerous, as you can see, if you don't jump at the same time as you shoot.
Alert. The monitor has disabled all.
You can like alter the damage you get by shooting the rocket at an angle. Press E and then reload. Press this one. You don't have to reach for the orange pointer this time. And if you see it closing like this, just throw a frag and it will destroy it. Or not. Okay, if the frag is not close enough, this one apparently doesn't explode.
Engine room located. We're here. Alert. The monitor has disabled all commands.
So that's why you need to be fast as well. If you're fast, then that vent won't start closing yet. This time it will close. This should be good. I think. Yeah. This time they both got destroyed because I see no orange pointer.
Step one complete. We have a straight shot into the fusion reactor. We need a catalyst explosion to destabilize the magnetic containment field surrounding the fusion cell. Use an explosive. I recommend.
I think they both got destroyed. No, they didn't. You can see by these lights are red and this one is yellow. So this one still needs to be. Alright, that's not how you do it. Where am I? Yeah. Alright, that works as well. Even if it's closing, it's pretty weird which works and which doesn't. Does that work? Yeah, that does work. Yeah, these floods can be annoying as well. Alright. That's the other strat.
Analyzing.
Saves 8 seconds if you do it well.
Engine reactor number 1 destabilizing. Use explosives on the other 3 reactors. That should be enough to
I already get a checkpoint. What you do here is you can walk under here, melee him, shoot him. And then you need to jump. It's necessary that you jump. If you don't jump, then the lift will like go up without you. So you need to jump after killing these guys. I wait with killing these guys because they drop plasmas as well, and the chain reaction from the fuel rod will like kill me, or it might kill me. If you don't go under that lift, then you don't need to jump. The lift to get to pick you up. You can wait on like this side of the lift. That's where the entrance is. Right. Move down here to get the health back. Once you get it, just enter. Press E. Slow down a little bit here. Or quite a bit actually, so you don't get like... you might flip if you go too fast or... Your turn will be a bit wide, that's the problem. Your turn will be wide and there's a plasma laying on the ground somewhere, or a fuel rod, and that will hit you. And going around these pillars is the fastest way to do this. And go through the middle. Those sentinels, if they come down and explode, that might hit you and they might actually flip you. Slow down here a bit, make the turn. But you can like easily get back into your warthog. But it loses you time. Sometimes. Alright, let's decide here. Try to focus. You can drive this way at the Sentinel part as well if you don't like the Sentinels very much, but it's pretty rare that you get flipped by a Sentinel Blast. This is Pillars again. But then mirrored. Don't stop here.
Position here.
Obviously.
Cortana to Echo 419.
We don't have time for full ammo.
Calculating alternate escape route.
This part can be like pretty hard to drive through, but it's,
now we can make it.
Well, it's not that hard actually. It might be bumpy. Slow down here again. Right, 360. If you just go down this, you will flip and you might die. So what we do is we do it 360. And it will like level out your warfog. And we do it by just before the end of the ramp. We turn. That was too early, as you can see, because I got all the way up here. So, and you don't have to turn that much. Well, like 90 degrees still, but. Or like just like 70 degrees. One more trick. Getting through the barrels with the warfog.
That's the ship. Move. We need to get aboard.
Look
now.
Right, look left, look right, and move back a bit, and then go forward again. And that right, left, right is just after you
That's
get stuck. Like,
we
I can't move from here,
now.
I can't move any further, so I look left, and I can't move any further, and I look right. And I said I looked right. Dang, I got too far. Alright, if you go too far in that, then you get stuck, apparently.
That's the ship. Move. We need
so
to get aboard now.
Look right, like this, and look left, and then look right again. And if your back gets stuck, just move backward, and then you will usually get unstuck. You can also try to get the god barrels,
That's
but I'm not really
ship.
Good at it.
Move.
I'm gonna try to show you. It consists of looking at like this, the side of the right, this yellow barrel, or yeah, yellow barrel, and about right here, you look to the left a bit. So like this, and then. I don't really know how it works, but that's the. I believe that's how it works.
That's the ship. Move. We need to get... That's the ship. Move. We need to get aboard.
Right. That's what it looks like. And then you can just move here. And that's the end of the speedrun.